Welcome, everybody, to the News Underground. I am Abandoned Nihilism, the harbinger of things to come. And like many things, I've been talking about Israel-Palestine for quite some time. And I have a lot to say on the matter, so let's just get to it while we bob our head to some wonderful Memphis 666 exclusives. That was Slick Wolf, got her tied to the tree. And of course, we're watching horrific footage from Gaza here. It's been tough. Where are the cupcakes, huh? Yeah, we're just gonna bake cupcakes now, you know? I mean, it has been legitimately difficult for me to stream for obvious reasons. It has been legitimately difficult for me to stream. Do I have my blur filter on here? See if I can get a blur filter going here. Did I not install that on this? No, I didn't. Fuck nuts, I didn't. All right, well, there you go. Professional operation, folks. Welcome back, Chem Goblin Loxley. Thank you very much for being here right off the bat. So, wanted to clear the air of what happened in the Discord today. Chem Goblin's in the Discord. I'm not sure if you are, Loxley, but as expected, I was accused of being... Welcome back, Davey. I was accused of being biased. I was accused of supporting Hamas simply because I'm not buying the hospital story from Israel immediately. I'm going to be presenting a lot of evidence that is making me lean towards Israeli story, you know, the story that's coming from the Israeli government. But I'm also going to be presenting some evidence to the contrary. And I don't feel... Because of the fact that Israel has bombed hospitals in the past, because Israel has already bombed checkpoints and other civilian areas already. Dusted. Sorry. So I'm skeptical because Israel, and look, this is going to be hard for a lot of sycophants, a lot of apologists, but Israel lies a lot. Israel lies all the time about everything, any bad thing that they've ever done. The default is to lie, and only later, once pressured by the international community, mainly the United States, will they quietly admit wrongdoing. There's many examples, but if you want a recent example, you can look towards the woman journalist, the Palestinian journalist that was killed. We're going to get her name in one of these segments here. It'll come up. I'll make sure to point it out. Sorry, I don't have it on hand. But she was shot square in the head by an IDF sniper intentionally because she was actually rather popular. It was an attempt to destroy the Palestinians' morale. Israel lied about it, said, oh, it wasn't us. It was a stray bullet from, you know, Hamas or something. You know, who knows? They lied about it, and only months later did they admit it. By the way, the IDF was also ordered to harass her funeral. Yeah, Davey, that's a great point. Sure. Yeah, I mean, this whole canard... And we're going to see it in full force in some of these interviews, because it is just constant. And honestly, I see it on both sides. From you're going to see a representative of, you know, the Palestinian Authority, you know, just outright refusing to admit that his side has committed any crimes and saying, well, everything Israel has done is a lie. Everything Israel says is a lie. So you got both sides saying we can do no wrong. Anyway, these are points that I've made a million times well before this started. And if you've been watching the stream long enough, you would know that's true. But let me clear out the air here. I had to ban somebody from my Discord because they said I was, agreeing with Hamas, or, you know, this is apologetics for Hamas. And look, it's one thing to disagree with me. It's another thing to just come out with, I mean, you know, with a profile covered in Israeli flags and just immediately on the attack. This person then DM'd me and said, I knew you were an echo chamber. So it's, look, there, my channel is not perfect, but there is one thing that this channel is not, and that is an echo chamber. This channel is constantly questioning narratives, constantly trying to dig into stories and accusations, trying to provide context, trying to provide nuance. Yeah, they also said they support Israel for religious reasons. What a stupid reason to support a side. And look, it's like, you know, and they posted free Israel. Free Israel from what? Themselves? They're, you know, this insistence on a victimhood mentality. We are the eternal victims, and everything we do is justified from that angle as victims. There are political philosophers. I wish I could name them, but I'm too fucking stoned. But there are political philosophers who have pointed out a country that bases its identity off of victimhood is a weak country, is a country that is not on stable ground, because the justifications are constant. And it also, you know, it prevents you from having accountability and moving forward on a stable foundation. Doesn't make a lot of sense, I guess, you know, but I'm just very frustrated, because if there's one thing that I do really, really well, that is provide nuance and provide context. And I guarantee you those 3 days of coverage that I did before I took my trip here to San Jose, there was no praising of Hamas. There was no celebrating of Hamas. I actually made the point that the Palestinians need to reject Hamas immediately, that Hamas is doing Palestine no favors. And I criticize and shit on supporters of Palestine that make excuses for the mass murder and straight up barbarity of Hamas. I call them out. And I'm going to be doing it again here coming up. I just wanted to get this clear. I of course I don't support Hamas, okay? But the situation is more complicated than what side are you on, as if we're dealing with two sides. I think Hamas is disgusting. What? Whatever, Davey. I think the Palestinian people need to accept that they're not going to get proper representation from a terrorist organization. And I think the people that are on TV and going around on the media, and I'm going to show you a couple of them, and are straight up denying Hamas's crimes, I think they're doing a disservice to the Palestinian people. But let's get to it here. I don't support Hamas. I've never supported Hamas. It's obvious. And look, the bad actors that are coming at me and immediately throwing out those accusations, because what? Because I'm not agreeing 100% with the Israeli narrative. The Israeli right-wing Israeli government that is on the record lying about all kinds of shit. Bibi Netanyahu, who's trying to destroy the democracy that, you know, that exists in Israel, trying to, you know, take over the judiciary. I'm supposed to believe this regime that has lied and lied and lied, and yes, has never acknowledged Palestine's existence. Israel has never acknowledged Palestine's existence. They've only acknowledged the PLO as a negotiating body. I'm supposed to, that a regime that has absolutely definitely bombed Gazan hospitals in the past So yeah, I'm going to be a little skeptical, especially the timing of it all. They had the narrative ready first thing in the morning. But honestly, there's a lot of evidence that shows that, you know, if Israel wants to bomb something, trust me, they can bomb it and blow it up. I think the strongest evidence that this was a fuck up by Hamas is the fact that the damage is not nearly as bad as it should be if it was a JDAM or some other U.S. made armament that we provide Israel with. It's good to note, you know, none of the mainstream fucking news clips that I'm going to show here acknowledge that these are U.S. weapons. These are U.S. bombs paid for by U.S. taxpayers. Such a ridiculous canard, man. I mean, I literally said in the Discord, if I had my finger on the trigger, I'd pull it, in reference to Hamas. They're monsters. They're monsters. How dare you attack me and say I support these people because I'm trying to make an argument for the Palestinian people? That's disgusting. And you should be ashamed of yourself, person who was in the Discord. That's really cruel. That's really disgusting. That's a horrible thing to accuse somebody of. Especially when I've been so adamant, when I've been so fucking adamant about how much I hate these idiots and how much damage I think that they're doing for the Palestinian cause. So fuck you. Stay banned. I just wanted to point this out real quick. Israel had to be persuaded. I don't know, Davin. I mean, you know, I don't know how valuable speculating on something like that would is. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's juicy, it's interesting. But if I was in any way connected to Hamas, right, my family was there or something, I'd be very, very careful about what I say. So you do bring up an interesting point. Because I hate these sons of bitches, and I'm afraid of them. I mean, they are legitimately terrifying. You know, just I was afraid of Wagner. They were legitimately. Have you seen some of the shit that Wagner does? Go to Live Link and type in Wagner, and come back to me after you've talked to a therapist. I'm scared of these people. I don't want to give them power. And you know what Hamas wants? A fucking invasion. They would love nothing more than for Israel to occupy northern Gaza. It's part of the plan. These people are monsters. And look at the position that they're putting the Palestinian people in. They praise their deaths. Oh, yay, more martyrs. You've created more martyrs. They're disgusting, horrific nihilists. And I despise them with every fucking fiber of my being. So when you come out there and you ignore everything I've said and you make some pithy fucking, oh, he loves Hamas, fuck you. And I'm not talking about you, Devin. I'm talking about motherfuckers in my Discord that I had to take care of. But I wanted to point this out. Israel to allow entry of humanitarian aid to Gaza from Egypt after U.S. pressure. After U.S. pressure. So Israel tells the Palestinians, you got to get out. Get the fuck out of northern Gaza. We're going to fuck it up. And then they proceed to do so. Then they bomb the fucking checkpoint with Egypt, right? A bunch of people just trying to leave, trying to get out of here. They bomb it. And they don't allow, supplies to come through Egypt. So Joe Biden had to ask and beg and cajole Bibi Netanyahu to do this, and then he's like, oh yeah, you know, he talks a big, oh, I'm so charitable, we're so charitable, but we're gonna fuck you up if any of this stuff goes to Hamas, like the 2 million plus innocent civilians in Palestine have any fucking choice about where this shit ends up. And here's Bibi Netanyahu saying if any of this stuff goes to Hamas, we're gonna, you know, let me see what he says here. Israeli early days. Did this article change? Yeah, he stressed that if Hamas steals the aid or diverts it, it would prove that the militant group doesn't care about the Palestinian population. We don't need proof. We don't need proof of that. Need another asteroid to restart the clock. See, that's the nihilism that I fight. It is funny, though. Not nihilism is funny. But no, I mean, yeah, that's going to prove a point that they don't care about the Palestinian population. Wow, congratulations. So you're going to fucking murder them? He added that the international community would halt aid shipments to Gaza in such a case. Bro, I mean, he knows that's what's going to happen. He knows some of this shit is going to get, that Hamas is going to get their hands on some of this shit. Why? And people are telling me, oh, Israel doesn't want to kill civilians. Israel doesn't want to kill civilians. So why are they fighting tooth and nail to trap these people? And then, and drop fucking bombs on them, man, every day. You put people in a cage, and then you drop bombs on them. You throw fucking grenades into the cage. So with that being the reality, with that being the reality, doesn't matter where you go, north, south, they're bombing the whole Gaza Strip. So no matter what direction you go in, you're getting fucked up. So now Gaza families that have been ordered south, they're starting to return home. Say nowhere is safe from Israeli bombs. It doesn't matter where we go. We can't leave. We're trapped. Fuck it. Might as well die in my home. Might as well die in my home. I get it. I get it. Right? If you're going to kill me in the South, I might as well die sitting on my fucking couch. So here we go. We got some long clips here. This is a long one, but this covers everything. And I have a lot to say on the various interviews that we're going to see here. This will enrage you. This is essential. This is 45 minutes of essential information. The journalists, they do an okay job, but I feel like the journalists could push a little bit more, but I don't know. But let's get into it here. This is essential viewing. This is absolutely essential viewing. Thank you for being here, by the way. I had to get that off my chest immediately.
If the atmosphere in the region was already incendiary, last night's explosion,
have a good night, Kem Gobble,
in Gaza fanned the flames. Enraged protesters took to the streets in the occupied West Bank and in cities across the Arab world. U.S. President Joe Biden landed in Tel Aviv today and quickly made clear that he stood by the Israeli claim that it was not their strike, but a misfired rocket from a militant group which caused the carnage. The explosion happened at about 7.
No, and you're gonna see interviews with people who are representing Palestine straight up denying the atrocities of Hamas. This shit's on camera. This shit's on film. This isn't doctored. This isn't fake. And it is, you're doing a disservice to the truth, and you're doing a disservice to the Palestinian people by denying the horrors that Hamas has committed, and then just being, well, you know, we're oppressed, which is true. Palestine is oppressed, but you're not helping the argument to become, you know, to have the moral high ground against Israel while you're defending this barbarity, man. There's no way to defend it. There's no fucking way to defend this. Right. And all these large lefty streamers that are out here rubbing their hands and doing apologetics for Hamas because they're worried it gives Israel credibility. Pull your head out of your ass. Understand the necessity of the moral high ground when it comes to an argument like this. And yeah, oh, you're so privileged because you're from the West. So I can't tell the Palestinian people how to act. Fuck that. I tell everybody how to fucking act, okay? I point out the motherfucking elephants in the room. Why the fuck would I give Palestine a break? Okay? And the elephant in the fucking room when it comes to Palestine is the fact that they are not marching and chanting and saying, we fucking reject Hamas. We deny Hamas. We do not want... No. That's an important thing. That needs to happen. People need to see that. And we're already seeing a lot of counter, you know, actually it's really positive pushback, and insistence that, hey, there's a difference between Hamas and the Palestinian civilians. I've seen it on fucking Morning Joe, okay? I've seen it on Morning Joe, which is a tonal shift from how this used to be covered in the past. It used to be Israel can do no wrong, you know, dirty, evil Palestinians, whatever, on to the next story. But no, we're actually seeing, I don't know if this barbarity is justified Israel, and they're doing it in a weak way, but we're seeing this. So like, now is the time to reject these violent terrorist tactics and push for a real peace solution. And yes, the Palestinian people need to get involved on that. I do watch Morning Joe because I hate myself. I'm addicted to news. I watch all news, dude. I watch news 24/7. The moment you'll see me in the Discord, the moment I end the stream, I'll be posting news because I immediately go back to watching the news. I'm fucking crazy. Let's get back to it.
10 p.m. last night at the crowded Al Ahli Hospital, the Hamas-run Gaza Health Ministry says that 471 people were killed. This morning, President Biden arrived in Tel Aviv to offer support to Israel, but a planned summit with the leaders of the Palestinian Authority, Jordan, and Egypt was abruptly canceled.
Hey, I watch it so you don't have to.
Canceled last night. In the occupied West Bank today, Palestinians joined protests in several major cities. And in Beirut, water cannon and tear gas were used on protesters outside the U.S. Embassy. And we should warn you again that there are some extremely distressing images from the beginning of this report by our foreign affairs correspondent, Sikander Kamani.
Yeah, so I got to be careful here.
They're everywhere. There aren't enough body bags to hold them.
I'll describe what I see. Dead bodies everywhere.
Two children.
Dead children's feet.
In a single blanket.
Dead children's feet.
How to make sense of such an awful scene? Imagine looking for someone.
More dead bodies.
Like this.
Dead bodies everywhere.
Israelis and Palestinians blame
dead
each
bodies,
other for the
blood,
strike on a hospital in Gaza
dead bodies
City.
Everywhere, blood.
What's clear is the suffering it caused.
So look, just to give you a quick explanation of what we're seeing here, this man was asked to look through the pile of bodies to see if he identified a family member, and he did. Maybe a wife, maybe a mother, maybe a sister, maybe a child. The crimes of Hamas are despicable. Responding to the crimes of Hamas by quadrupling, by doing a, you know, a massacre 4 times, 10 times the scale, I can't agree with that. There's no defense for. There's no real moral defense for that action. Okay? They didn't send in commandos to have fights with Hamas. They just started leveling buildings filled with innocent people. And as I explained at the beginning of the stream, actively blocking people from leaving. And tell me, what country normally has full control over electricity and water of the other country it's fighting? If there was ever a clear example of how the power dynamic and how Israel has full control over the situation, it's the fact that they could just turn the water off. Welcome back, Snow.
I was sitting with my uncle, and then suddenly a bomb went off in the middle of the hospital. We heard screaming, and then I ran out. I can't even begin to explain how fast I ran. There were dead bodies, corpses, ripped arms and legs. I don't know what to say.
There's a fight to save lives in the most desperate of conditions.
Holy shit. Holy shit.
Patients,
lots of blood. Lots of fucking torn up limbs.
Starting to process what's
holy
just
fucking shit, man.
In a place they thought would be safe. Doctors in Gaza were already barely able to cope. In the aftermath of the blast, they've been overwhelmed with patients. This
holy
is the
fucking
Al-Ali
shit.
Baptist Hospital that was struck. Burnt
thank
out
you, Snow.
Cars filled the courtyard that would have been full of those seeking medical help and shelter.
Oh my God,
is this
dude.
The result of an Israeli airstrike or a malfunctioning rocket fired by Palestinian militants. Israeli officials have denied responsibility, presenting what they say is a tranche of evidence, including this video, according to some, showing a rocket exploding midair, then falling and causing an explosion. Though like so much, it's contested.
I mean, are the tanks moving? Are we talking it's like really, it's happening like right fucking now? Is that what you're saying? You got to give me a link.
Arriving in Tel Aviv today, the US president. A show of solidarity by Israel's staunchest ally. And Joe Biden was quick to make clear he believes Israel was not behind the bloodshed last night.
I was deeply saddened and outraged by the explosion at the hospital in Gaza yesterday. And based on what I've seen, it appears as though it was done by the other team, not you.
Yeah, I guess we could criticize him on the team shit. I don't know, man. Whatever. I got bigger fish to fry.
Meeting survivors of the horrific massacre committed by Hamas, Biden vowed to continue support for Israel's security. But he's also hoping to secure much-needed humanitarian relief for Gaza as civilian casualties rise.
It's just not the example of our power, it's the power of our example. It's almost as important. The world's looking. Israel has a value set like the United States does and other democracies. And they're looking to see what we're going to do.
I have a lot to say on the pending invasion and pending occupation, why it's happening and what the goal is. I have two words, ethnic cleansing. I was warning about this last year, about how it was very clear to me from Bibi Netanyahu's statements and Ben Gavir's statements that this was that they were going to accelerate and double down on the occupation strategy, and that it was only a matter of time before they implement the next step in the takeover of Palestine, complete the erasure of Palestine. Because yes, the goal is to destroy the Palestinian country, to completely absorb all territories. And, you know, I don't know, we'll figure out what we do with the, it's just under 6 million people, I think, total in the West Bank and Gaza Strip. There's talk about dumping them in Jordan. Of course, Jordan doesn't want that. Talk about dumping them in Egypt. Egypt wants nothing to do with that. There is flirtation with just, why don't we just, you know, fucking Roblox them all? We see extremists that support Ben Gavir say things like that. And I can show you examples if you want to see people in the streets calling for the death of all Palestinians. It's very easy. Just like you can look up Palestinians cheering for the death of Israelis. It's very easy. But I've said for a long time, the goal is to destroy Palestine, to take over Palestine. And this occupation is part of that. That's why we're seeing the 9/11 framing. It's they're going to take it and they're not going to give it back. And Israel, it's good to note that Israel has never respected the right to return, which is, humanitarian law. It's one of the reasons why the United Nations and other international bodies call out Israel, because they've ever done is kicked out Palestinians from their territory. They've never allowed them to return. After what they call temporary occupation, they call it a temporary. It's not temporary. It's a takeover. They let Israelis move in, own property, the whole nine. So that's the long and the short of my belief of what the goal of this occupation is. So it really doesn't surprise me that they're going to go through with it. And honestly, the United States leaders are cowards. I mean, I understand Israel is an important military satellite. But this fealty to the hyper-corrupt, extremely authoritarian, right-wing Israeli government is just pathetic. Is fucking pathetic. So that's what I have to say on those things. I also saw that they are expecting the invasion to take multiple years. It takes a long time to kick all those people out, especially because, honestly, the Palestinian people, I think they're going to see much more resistance from men, women, and children. They're going to see civilians getting involved now, because this is it. This is, you know, there's no room for 1 million people to cram into southern Gaza. This is it. They need, this is kind of a final stand kind of situation. And I think the Israeli military is going to have to go full blown, kill everybody, you know, and they're going to put themselves in the crosshairs of Hamas, which is exactly what they wanted. And I think they're going to find it's going to be very, very difficult to empty out the around a million people. They're going to find it very difficult to do that. But I think they're going to make a go of it. I think they're going to make, good old college try. I think they're going to give it a shot and see if they can get away with it. And of course, the United States, oh, please don't, please don't, please, oh, please don't. But I'm not an anti-Semite. Oh, please don't call me that. But maybe you could don't do that, please. Oh, geez. So that's what we're going to fucking see. That's my prediction.
In the occupied West Bank and across the Arab world, many remain convinced Israel was behind the strike on the hospital.
America, America doesn't give a shit about American hostages, quite frankly. The hostages, they're not even part of the fucking equation. Okay, and I think, you know, I mean, well, that's not totally fair. America is happy to negotiate, and, you know, and there's famous examples just recently, Brittany Griner, right, of America getting back its hostages. But honestly, I think the United States government will pick Israel over American hostages any day. And if Israel were to drop a JDAM on a building filled with American hostages, Joe Biden would be on camera and in front of a mic making apologetics for the Israeli government's murder of American citizens the moment it's confirmed. We would see apologetics from the United States government for the murder of hostages. I think Joe Biden is I do think though that Joe Biden right now, you know, he's on the public face of Joe Biden is Israel can do no wrong, you know, just like it's never changed. We've been supporting Israel 12 minutes into their existence, yada, yada, yada. I think that's the public face. But I think the private face is pressure, pressure, pressure. We're not joking. Don't you fucking do this. We're not actually fucking with you. There will be punishment if you do this. I think that's what's happening in the background, because this hesitation, they're all ready to go. They're all set. And we see this massive hesitation. I think that's where that's coming from, is this pressure campaign coming from the United States government saying, you don't want that. We can't support this. We're already receiving pushback on Morning Fucking Joe about the slaughter that you're doing even pre-invasion. It's going to be very difficult for us to toe this line. We don't have full control over our media like other, you know, despots and, you know, other authoritarian governments. So I think that's what we're seeing here.
Protests erupting instantaneously.
Davey, back the fuck off, okay? Back the fuck off. Don't be calling people a joke just because you disagree with them. But I disagree with Rebel Phoenix and what he's saying. But let's chill out with the motherfucking name calling, okay? I don't want to ban all the people that come into my channel. That's what's going to happen, though, isn't it? I'm just going to ban everybody. Yeah, that's what's going to happen. Welcome back, Lenny, by the way, if I didn't say it. Thank you for being here, Lenny.
The head of the Palestinian Authority canceled a planned meeting with President Biden. Fueling the anger.
Jesus Christ. Okay, they're literally doing a press conference. Okay, they have it all blurred out, so I can show you. But they're doing, I mean, look at this press conference. They're doing it in a pile of bodies. You know, how does Uncle Sam, how does MSNBC back this up? How, right?
Prince last night, officials in Gaza surrounded by the bodies of dead children, accusing the Israeli army of being behind their deaths. A member of Gaza's health
more
ministry
Lenny.
Says hospital staff
welcome back
had
clutch,
been warned
by the way.
To evacuate by the military, and it had been hit by Israeli shelling just days earlier. Israelis have accused the media of being too quick to accuse them of the bloodshed. A lot of people...
I think, as dishonest as Israel is, I think that's fair right now, and I'm going to play a clip from a different commentator who makes a good point. He basically says, if you're certain on one side or the other, you know, you're being delusional. You know, because I think if you're being an honest person right now, you have to admit that there really isn't strong enough evidence for either side. And, you know, there's strong circumstantial evidence for one side or the other, but we need real independent forensic analysis of this, because it's you know, anyone, you could fake this shit. It's, you know, you can, Israel could, I don't know. There's a million different things that could have been done here. I do know one thing for certain. Israel has 100% confirmed bombed Gazan hospitals in the past. That has absolutely happened. That is part of a pattern here. But right now, the evidence for the hospital bombing, the evidence shows, you know, it mostly, I mean, it, right now, the circumstantial evidence shows that it might have been Hamas. You know, I don't know, maybe it was shot down, maybe it failed mid-launch, something like that. But this, I'm not an expert. No one in the fucking chat is an expert, by the way. So let's just sit on this one for a bit, right? Let's not take a hard stance on this one, right? It's just like the pipeline. It's just like that fucking pipeline. It's like, yeah, well, I guess, you know, if you pile up all the evidence, it looks like the United States probably did it, but there's a lot of circumstantial evidence for other meddling, you know, and it's, you can't be 100% certain on the pipeline. And right now, honestly, you can't be 100% certain on the hospital right now. And if you are, you're, come on, man, you gotta, you know, you honestly, you do need to bump up your nuance meter, right? I mean, because the Israeli government has a history of lying and telling half truths and all kinds of different things, man. We're not dealing with an honest actor in the Israeli government. That's a fact.
Don't believe the Israeli version of events regarding this hospital strike in Gaza. Isn't that because in the past,
fair enough,
Israel,
David,
has repeatedly struck civilian targets and not being...
Okay, this is important. I don't want to interrupt this. This is an interview with an IDF guy. And look at how he answers these questions. He's literally, the IDF guy is answering questions that were not even asked of him. And there's no pushback. Come on, where's the pushback?
Believe the Israeli version of events regarding this.
Israelis have accused the media of being too quick to accuse them of the bloodshed.
A lot of people don't believe the Israeli version of events regarding this hospital strike in Gaza. Isn't that because in the past, Israel has repeatedly struck civilian targets and not been open about it?
The IDF is absolutely clear in targeting the enemy, targeting Hamas, Islamic Jihad, and those terror organizations. And it was clear to us that we do not target hospitals. It was absolutely clear.
They have done it in the past. They're absolutely targeting civilians right now. It's 100% provable. It's undeniable. To deny it is to just be a, you know, to be a dishonest person, to lie to people, to deny it.
To us that there had to be another explanation.
Lots of Israelis were killed here. Lots of people in Gaza are being killed now. Hasn't history shown us there's no military solution to this conflict?
I think that is the clear lesson of history, that murder.
I mean, listen, this is a classic technique where you agree with the person, and then the things that you say are in total disagreement of what the question. So you go, yep, you know, yeah, I totally acknowledge that. And then what you say is in complete opposition to that.
Into this conflict, killed now. Hasn't history shown us there's no military solution to this conflict?
I think that is the clear lesson of history, that murderous terrorist organizations need to be stopped, and the IDF is absolutely...
Sir, do you acknowledge that there's no military solution to this problem, that Israel is going to have to come to the table to do some bargaining? Yes, absolutely. I think we need to eliminate Hamas with military means and destroy them and kill all Hamas. Yes, totally. I agree with your statement that there isn't a military solution. So let me just propose a military solution. It's madness, and they get away with it, man. It's that you're going to see another person who's just barreling through like a robot, just refusing to acknowledge reality. Refusing, and then I'm going to show you a Palestinian guy doing the exact same thing, dude.
Lots of people in Gaza are being killed now. Hasn't history shown us there's no military solution to this conflict.
I think that is the clear lesson of history, that murderous terrorist organizations need to be stopped, and the IDF is absolutely committed to doing that.
How successful was George Bush's war on terror? You're going to see this claim that we destroyed ISIS. ISIS isn't destroyed. What are you talking about? United States was able to destroy ISIS with a massive bombing campaign. How come we can't? We didn't. The hell we did.
Is the clear lesson of history that murderous terrorist organizations need to be stopped, and the IDF is absolutely committed to doing that.
That wasn't the question, dude.
Throughout the day in Gaza, funerals for those killed in the blast at the hospital.
Yeah,
we
Lenny,
can't say
I agree.
For certain who was responsible. What is clear is as Israel's retaliatory bombardment continues, many more will die.
Well, officials here, and particularly Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, were very pleased with how this visit has gone.
There you go,
President
David.
Biden came out in strong support of Israel, saying that
the country must
again become a safe place for the Jewish people and promising to do everything in his power to make that happen. Later this week, President Biden is going to ask Congress to approve a massive military aid package, which Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has said will aid the war effort that's continuing here. But President Biden also announced $100 million of support, humanitarian aid for the West Bank and Gaza, and he cautioned Israel on its response. A lot of people here have compared the awful attack committed by Hamas to the 9/11 attacks committed in America. President Biden...
And look, I'm not going to go on a super long thing here, but this framing is intentional. That we saw this immediately. It's an intentional framing. It was, you know, I'm not going to sit here and say, you know, it's still a conspiracy theory that, you know, Bibi Netanyahu knew this was going to happen and allowed it to happen. But I think it's fair to say, you know, that once it did happen, they thought very carefully about the framing. And I do believe this 9/11 framing is not just a thing that just happened organically by the media, you know, by talking heads making comparisons. I do believe it was a very intentional framing. And I think the reason why is because the intention is to occupy and take, cut Gaza in half, man, cut it right in half.
Biden said that after those September the 11th, 11th attacks,
that's terrible,
America,
Davey.
Sought justice and got justice.
Fuck terrorists.
Also consumed by its rage.
Like it needs to be
mistakes.
Said.
And he was warning Israel not to go down the same path. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has made some small concessions following Biden's visit. He has said that Israel will not oppose the transfer of water, food and medicine from Egypt into Gaza across the Rafah crossing, though there are still many unclear details about how that aid will be distributed. And there's still no clarity about whether electricity or fuel will be allowed into Gaza. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu also saying that no aid will be allowed into Gaza from Israeli territory until hostages are released by Hamas.
Sorry.
Sikandar, thank you very much indeed. So what do we actually know about yesterday's hospital blast?
I know.
And the contradicting claims by Israel and Hamas, which is designated a terrorist organization by the UK. It has been impossible to carry out any independent verification. But our chief correspondent, Alex Thompson, has been examining the evidence presented by both sides so far. And a warning, this report contains distressing images from...
All right, hold on. What happened to my fucking camera? What? This doesn't even make any sense. Hold on. God damn, dude. You literally do one thing. You flip one fucking switch and the whole thing goes to shit. All right, I'm back. I know. Thank you, everybody. I'm back.
From the start.
All right, I gotta watch out for this.
Last night, as every night, news agency cameras locked off in Gaza to record the explosions. At 10 to 7, they pick up what appears to be a rocket above Gaza, apparently exploding in midair. Shortly after...
So this is the evidence that Israel is presenting as proof. I'm surprised we don't have more angles on this. That's one thing that surprised me, is that we don't seem to have multiple angles on this. And we know that there are dozens of cameras, dozens of angles. We get them with every major explosion, multiple angles. So I'm hoping that we can get more information, more analysis.
Two explosions. The second, believed to be in the hospital car park, causes a large and immediate fire. There's no proof that the mid-air and ground explosions are necessarily linked. We spoke to one eyewitness.
I live very near to the hospital, and we have seen, you know, the neighboring area have seen the bombs dropping on the hospital. The explosion was so massive and so huge, and the mountain fire rising up into the sky was so horrible. We instantly knew that this is the Ahli Arab Hospital. It's the Baptist Hospital, the oldest Christian hospital in Gaza Strip.
Dr. Mohammed Al-Naka said there was no warning, and about 3,000 people were sheltering here. He said, we don't know what it was, but we know what it can do after it targeted children who were cut to pieces. Gaza's Hamas-controlled health ministry says 471 people were killed. If so, that's by far the worst single loss of life for Palestinians in all the long wars with Israel. Doctors held a press conference.
And folks, if you want an uncensored view of this video, you can get that from the Discord.
Standing in the middle of a makeshift mortuary. It is clear scores of people at least were killed. Moreover, the Archbishop of Canterbury has said the hospital was attacked at the weekend, at least 4 civilians injured. And on Sunday, the Israelis phoned up telling everybody to evacuate. Gaza today, damage caused by an Israeli airstrike. Concrete buildings pancaked, structural collapse over a wide area, splash marks of shrapnel. Large craters are usual if the missile hits open ground as opposed to a building, like a car park. This is what you see at the hospital today.
Yeah,
craters you'd expect from a mortar strike or artillery round, not a missile. Surrounding buildings have only superficial damage, not structural collapse. Some of the windows of an adjoining church remain intact. This makes a ground detonating Israeli missile strike unlikely, but it doesn't rule out an airburst munition, which could cause major loss of life, but would produce far less structural damage.
And that's what I was thinking when I first saw the video, that like this looks like one of those airburst things, you know. And I think I've shown videos pertaining to Ukraine, where it's kind of like a cluster munition. It explodes above and then showers shrapnel and explosive and small explosives down directly. And if you look at the video, it does go right over that area, explode, and then you see these orange things coming down directly over what looks like the hospital. I haven't seen verification of these things, but we'll just go with that the video is not doctored. We'll just agree with that for now. But yeah, that it did look like some kind of airburst munition. You know, because like if it was shot down, the trajectory was, you know, it was shot down, you would continue with some kind of trajectory. It wouldn't stop and then shower directly downward. That would be more like an airburst munition that is designed to do that.
So what then of Israel's explanation?
We'll go through your guys' links a little later. Thank you.
To get their version out. Press conference first thing.
Good morning, everybody.
Conclusion, a misfiring Islamic Jihad rocket caused it all.
According to our intelligence. The timing is super suspect. I mean, they had this narrative ready to go.
Hamas checked the reports, understood it was an Islamic Jihad rocket that had misfired.
But they might have expedited this and like, no, we need to do first thing in the morning. We need to make a statement so that, you know, people don't blame us for this. So that it could be totally legitimate why they would, you know, be out there first thing in the morning as well. I want to acknowledge that.
And decided to launch a global media campaign to hide what really happened.
They present what they say is two Hamas operatives talking about the attack.
I mean, Davin, we saw that, you know, that legitimate stray missile that Ukraine fired at Russia. And I think Russia shot it down, and it landed right on, what was it, a Polish farmer's house, like a fucking farmhouse in the middle of fucking nowhere, you know, and it lands right on this guy's house. So, you know, I'm not going to rule out this, you know, this story yet, but I just have so little trust in the right wing Israeli government. I've never, especially since Bibi took it over, but even before then, you know, but I mean, especially with Bibi and Ben are the absolute worst right wing Israeli government that has ever been, that has ever happened. It's never been more right wing. I mean, I don't think religion would prevent Israel from doing any of this. We've seen Israel, you know, send the IDF into the Al-Aqsa Mosque to, you know, to desecrate it. I don't think Israel is concerned with religion, right? So if the theory that they did it, I don't think they would be, oh, no, we can't do it because it's Christian. I don't think they give a shit about that. What they give a shit about is power and, you know, completing this project to take the Palestinian country, to take the rest of it. That's what they're concerned with.
Hamas call this an obvious fabrication. Two independent Arab journalists told us the same thing because of the language, accent, dialect.
Okay, thank you, Davey. Would you mind posting that link in the chat? I will absolutely play that CNN. I did not watch that one, so go ahead and put that link in my chat. And we'll play that once this video is over with.
Syntax and tone, none of which is, they say, credible. Equally, Israel claims the Islamic Jihad failed missile was fired from here, a cemetery very close to the hospital. But look again at the video of the event. The trajectory of the missile doesn't line up with that location. Too high, too horizontal. Confusingly, the Israeli
Benatow, thank you for being here. I just want to say, I, you know, you could be right, though. You know, I mean, honestly, I'm on the fence. I'm not taking a specific stand at the moment here. I'm just trying to game theory this out. But yeah, I'm not taking a definitive stance on who bombed the hospital. I haven't taken a definitive stance on who bombed the pipeline. No matter what motherfuckers say, I still haven't, you know, said put my foot down on the pipeline. I don't fucking know. I'm leaning towards the United States. You know, and in this case, I'm leaning towards believing Israel that this was a Hamas misfire. But like I said, I don't trust Bibi and Ben. I don't trust them at all.
His presentation also says,
thank you, Davey,
the missile was fired from a location down in the southwest. It can't be both. Islamic Jihad.
So there you go. I mean, Channel 4 pointing out an interesting inconsistency with the official narrative.
Not with that location. Too high, too horizontal. Confusingly, the Israelis' presentation also says the missile was fired from a location down in the southwest. It can't be both. Islamic Jihad say it was an Israeli missile and they have the warhead to prove it, but they haven't produced it.
That's a good point, Davin.
I wanted to be here today.
So Joe Biden believes Israel, so does the UN. Much of the Arab world and many beyond it do not. And Israel has form when it comes to war propaganda. Its claims about not being responsible for shooting dead British filmmaker James Miller in Gaza.
Okay, so this is backing up what I'm saying to any of you clowns out there that are like, anti-Semite, you're an anti-Semite. Israel never lies. Israel is the good actor here. The bad actor is these brown people. They gotta go. To all you clowns out there trying to say that that Israel can do no wrong. Here's some evidence. Here's some receipts of how deceptive that they've been in the past.
Joe Biden believes Israel, so does the UN. Much of the Arab world and many beyond it do not. And Israel has form when it comes to war propaganda. Its claims about not being responsible for shooting dead
interesting
British
point,
filmmaker
Bentaro.
James Miller in Gaza 20 years ago were widely dismissed, not least by a British court. Israel denied shooting dead Palestinian-American photojournalist Sheree.
This is the journalist that I'm constantly referencing. This is, you know, this is her funeral right here. This funeral was disrupted by the IDF. The IDF literally took batons and started beating these men, their legs and their body while they're holding her body. This is how the Palestinians, you know, celebrate their dead. They parade them through the street. It's a cultural thing. But the IDF is like wailing on these guys' legs. You know, and they almost dropped the corpse. They almost dropped the body, man. And it's just disgusting. It's like you can't even have a funeral. You can't even have a fucking funeral in peace without the IDF coming in and brutalizing you.
Israel denied shooting dead Palestinian-American photojournalist Shireen Abu Akleh last year, only to backtrack later on admitting they probably did kill her.
And she was Palestinian-American. This is why I'm saying that that the United States pretends to give a shit about the hostages, that Israel is barely pretending to give a shit about the hostages. And look, you know, and we're going to see it in this interview, the fucking elephant in the room is the fact that you're not going to negotiate with Hamas while you're fucking bombing the entirety of the Gaza Strip. You got to stop the bombing. And they're like, I can't believe Hamas isn't coming to the table while we're mercilessly bombing them. Not them, but Hamas, but I mean, not just Hamas, but everyone in Palestine. Would you come to the table?
Just two examples from a long track record. And as we've seen, Israel has already attacked this hospital. And yesterday, it's accused of bombing a UN-protected school, killing several civilians.
So check that out. I didn't even pick up on that. They've legitimately, yes, have attacked a hospital in this recent attack. You know, they've attacked hospitals in the past, and they've done it again.
And as we've seen, Israel has already attacked this hospital. And yesterday, it's accused of bombing a UN-protected school, killing several civilians. Israel and Hamas can tweet what they like. The truth of what happened here last night requires independent, expert investigation. Not happening.
I mean, this is Channel 4, and you know, they have their own bias over here, but that it doesn't bode well that we're going to get any kind of truth anytime soon. You know, we're not going to get much truth about that pipeline, I can tell you that. Fuck, it took, what, 30 years to get any information about JFK? Where's my soundboard? Need
Alex
my soundboard.
Thompson reporting. Well, earlier I spoke to the Palestinian journalist and activist Noor Swerki, who was in Khan Yunis in the southern Gaza Strip with her children. Many Palestinians have been fleeing to the city since Israeli airstrikes began, and I began by asking her to describe the situation there today.
So the situation is still Khan Yunis. It's not only Khan Yunis, it's the Gaza Strip, all the Gaza Strip is under fire. Still there is airstrike.
Ben and Tao, that may or may not be true. Do you think it's right? Do you think that's a good thing that Israel is going to take over the whole region?
Shelling and bombing. There is targeting for residential buildings, for people, the civilians. Still, there is a threat to some facilities.
No, there were suggestions today that while President Biden is in Israel, the Israeli army might stop shelling the Gaza Strip. Is there any evidence that they stopped that today?
No, at all. They never stopping this shelling at all today. The shelling is still, the airstrike is still ongoing.
Fair enough, you didn't say Israel, but would you mind answering my question regardless?
And people are still losing their lives with this Israeli airstrikes.
And Noor, tell me about the water situation. Apparently, some water was shipped in, but there's no fuel to generate, you know, the pumps.
Silence,
and so on.
Rebel. It'll
What's
be silence.
What's the water situation like?
There is no supplies in the Gaza Strip regarding the fuel, regarding the water, the food, and the health tools and supplies.
How much water do you and your family have every day?
I'm talking for me and my family. We have only half liter per day to drink and to use per each person. For the issues of showering and cleaning our bodies and something like this, every 3 to 4 days. So since this war starting, every one of us only take one shower.
Noor, what are you telling your children about the situation under these very difficult circumstances?
Would like that
well,
answer,
they already,
Benito.
Known that there is a war. Because of this shelling, bombing, when we went to evacuate from the Gaza City. Today, I'm out in the field for my work, and they were keep hugging me and asking if I will be back or I may be injured or dead in the field.
And how many days do you think you can carry on with your kids like this?
we can't make them safe at all, because there is no safe place in the Gaza at all, because we already lost some of our relatives. Me, myself.
So when you see the death of civilians, you don't care? I mean, Israel or Palestine, you just don't really give a shit? Am I supposed to be, like, cool with that? Am I supposed to be okay with that? Because that's a really selfish and monstrous opinion. I couldn't disagree with that more. Like, at the very core of my being, I disagree with that mentality. I find it pathetic, in fact.
I lost my cousin yesterday, and I lost my friend, and so it's a tragedy. We are here just looking to survive and to still alive when this war ends.
No, one final question. Do you hold Hamas responsible? Because
so here we go, and this is a massive, massive problem for people that represent Palestine. This is a massive. What is so wrong with saying, look, I don't know how much of it is true, but I know some of it's true, and I disagree with all of it. I don't think, I disagree with Hamas, and I disagree with their actions. I don't know how much of it is true. There's some pushback on the, videos and pictures of, certain things that are being claimed that were done to children. Some of the most extreme things there. I don't know. Some are claiming that there isn't video evidence. There probably is. I mean, we don't. I have. It's not like I've seen all of it. I'm not looking for it. I really, really, really don't want to watch it. So it is. It is hard to tell the lies from the fake. But you can't make a simple statement of I think the actions. If any of it is true. You can't even soft like, yeah, if any of it is true, and I'm not sure it is true, but if any of it is true, then yes, it's disgusting and I disagree. You can't even give me that. It's pathetic. It's fucking pathetic. And if you're out here representing Palestine this way, I think you're doing a disservice to the Palestinian people, because I guarantee you, if you were to line up every, the 2.3 million Gazan civilians, maybe exclude the children, so because you're not asking them this question, but you ask them, do you think burning children and slitting their throats is a good thing? I think we'd get a lot of no's. And this idea that they're animals and that they deserve to be put down and that it's all justified. They don't know how, they're not civilized. I think is disgusting. Is positively disgusting. It is. But honestly, if you're representing Palestine and you're out here denying the reality, because some of this shit is filmed and I've seen it. I've seen some of this shit. It's unbelievable. They had the run, that festival massacre, they had the run of the festival for hours. They raped, murdered, and pillaged like it was the 1600s. They went from the kibbutz massacres, they went from house to house, kicking down the door and slaughtering, grandma and grandpa. Now, an argument can be made that grandma and grandpa shouldn't have been occupying Palestinian land, but none of that justifies the brutality. That problem of grandma and grandpa being on the fucking border of, being basically a border town occupying another country, the solution is political to that problem, right? Eventually, the Israeli government needs to be convinced to tell that man he needs to leave. Because we're unsettling some of this Palestinian land to give it back to them so that we can adhere to the 1967 borders, right? So that's a political solution. The solution isn't to kick down that man's door and slit his throat in front of his wife. That is not the fucking solution. So how in the fucking world can you come out here and deny that some of this shit is happening? Because it is on film. They filmed it. They were smiling and dancing while they were doing it. It is undeniable. And here we see representatives of Palestine that we're supposed to take serious, that we're supposed to feel sorry for, deny that shit. What the fuck am I supposed to say about that? How am I supposed to defend that? I can't. I absolutely cannot. I can only say that that people that are trying to make defense of the Palestinian people need to acknowledge that Hamas is a terrorist organization, that it is bad, and that the Palestinian people should reject it. At, you know, make some kind of statement against this. Don't play apologetics, whataboutism for Hamas. Is that too much to ask? Is it really too much to ask to not play apologetics and whataboutism for fucking Hamas?
No, one final question. Do you hold Hamas responsible because of the attack against Israel for the suffering that you're going through at the moment?
Well, I hold the occupation, this suffering.
Occupation. What about ism? Just no, we're not even gonna. And I see the Israelis do this too, you know, and I see the Israeli representatives do this too, man. Just no answer of the question.
Question is the root cause of these things.
Yeah, and you might, and she's correct. She's 100% correct. It is the occupation that's that is the root cause of this. But can you take 5 fucking seconds out of your life to acknowledge the barbarity, to acknowledge that that's wrong, please? Please, can you do that for the Palestinian people?
If there is no occupation, I believe there is no war at all. And
But your suffering has been made so much worse by the attacks, hasn't it?
So it's not about Hamas and this attack. It's about the occupation and its practice against us as Palestinians and the reaction against this.
I'm not going to pause. I disagree. I fucking vehemently disagree. It's not about Hamas. Come on.
Practice and violation against us as Palestinians.
We're just supposed to just forget about
to end this occupation and to let us as Palestinians and civilians.
We want to focus on the occupation, but do you know how difficult it is to take people like you seriously when you're asked a direct question? Is fucking killing people wrong? And you immediately kick into whataboutism?
Civilians protected and live in a dignified life and have our right to life.
Finally, Noor, what's your message to President Biden, who of course is visiting Israel today? What do you say to him?
To make his effort to stop this war.
Okay. Noor Sweki, thank you very much indeed for talking to us and good luck to you and your family.
Thank you.
Now, thousands of people have been out on the streets throughout the occupied West Bank calling for the overthrow of Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas and clashing with Palestinian Authority security forces. Protests sparked by the immediate outrage over the hospital blast in Gaza, but also the crackdown by Israeli forces throughout the territory, as we've been finding out in Ramallah. Translation: please, Hamas, bring us the revolution. They shouted today.
You see, and this is the problem. This is a problem. This is a massive problem. I get it. I get it. Because, like, you know, we go back to that, you know, wonderful person from the, you know, that was being interviewed on the BBC who said, this is like a prison break. These people are prisoners. And I think about, you know, what if I was a prisoner and some, you know, neo-Nazi that I disagree with, you know, was fucking up the prison guards who are constantly beating me, who are constantly oppressing me. And it's like, yeah, I don't agree with a neo-Nazi, but, you know, I agree, you know, I'm not going to shed a tear watching my oppressor get, you know, hurt. But Hamas is not going to provide a revolution. But the thing is that when you feel hopeless, If they're extreme elements, if they're willing to fight for you, if they're willing to push back against your oppressors, people will look past the barbarity. People will look past that. I'm not trying to make excuses for it, because like I said, I believe the Palestinian, and these people don't represent all of Palestine, by the way. Right? I mean, you know, but... You want the solution? If you feel frustrated, do you know what the solution is? The solution, it's actually rather simple. It's for Uncle Sam to pull the purse strings and say, we're not going to provide you with aid unless you get serious about giving back some of these settlements. Giving back some of these settlements, getting closer to the 1967 borders, sitting down, you know, creating a corridor between Gaza and the West and the and the western part of Palestine there, the West Bank. You got to get serious with it. The entity, and this is what frustrates me about Joe Biden, because he is the number one player here, and he is like on autopilot, seemingly. Like I said, that's the public face, is this autopilot, right? But it's disappointing because it's that leverage, it's the aid that we provide Israel that could be revoked, that could be leveraged to say, get serious here, stop being a bad actor. You need to accept the existence of Palestine, first of all. Get to the table and get serious about it. And look, honestly, American politicians have been cowards about Israel since its inception, right? Because of the military strategic usefulness of it, on top of a bunch of other biases and religion and all this other stuff, right? All this other nonsense. But really, it's about, well, we want a frontline, proxy in this Middle Eastern area.
Today in Ramallah, where the Palestinian Authority is supposed to hold sway, but where the streets increasingly belong to Hamas. Where the suffering of Palestinian civilians in Gaza is the new currency of unrest. And where last night's explosion at the Al Ahli Hospital in Gaza is the trigger that has enraged this crowd.
The violence isn't justified. The violence is never, especially what Hamas does, is not justified. But the anger is justified from the Palestinian people. And I've shown countless examples of what day-to-day life of a Palestinian person is before all this happened. The anger is justified. The violence is not. Yeah, Davey, that is correct. That is correct, and that is encouraging. That is encouraging. That is a good example of how the Biden statement did differ, from the normal script, is that he acknowledged that the Palestinian people are human and that that Hamas does not represent all the Palestinian people. I mean, this is a good-sized crowd, but this isn't 2.3 million people. It's a good-sized crowd, but it's not... this is the West Bank. So I think the West Bank has like 4 or 5 million people, something like that. But this is not the entirety of the Palestinian people. I mean, 40% of the West Bank is fucking kids, children.
Small glimpse of a bigger picture that terrifies Arab rulers who've been busy making peace with Israel. Waiting down the road in front of Palestinian government buildings, the riot police, poised to crack down. They haven't had an election in the West Bank in 17 years. Hamas is seizing the mandate from afar. The question, who was behind last night's explosion in Gaza, has become the litmus test of loyalty. I asked this Palestinian priest in Italian about Israel's version. All lies, all...
This doesn't help. All lies? We have this shit on, homie, you need to hit up Live Link, in between looking for them, big booty BBLs. You know what I'm talking about? Let's this guy likes it big and juicy. All right. So, maybe take a look at Live Link and take a look at some of the proof, man. That shit isn't doctored. They're shouting, they're wearing Hamas logos, shouting Allah Akbar and doing some of the fucking most heinous shit we've ever seen in our lives. I guarantee you. You will walk away scarred. Okay? So everything's fake. Everything's fake. Everything Israel says is a lie. This isn't helping. This does not help. And people on the left need to embrace nuance. What the hell happened? What the hell? Has it always been? Has political discourse always been like this? What the fuck happened to the left? Wasn't the left supposed to be an intellectual movement?
All lies, he told me. It is our people who are suffering in injustice.
Yeah, no, and that is 100% true. But I honestly do believe you're doing a disservice to that suffering by denying reality.
Because I'm a journalist.
I move down the crowd. At first, people are reluctant to speak. Then they open up and don't stop.
They've been saying we're going to bomb you. And they did it.
Mm. And they tweeted it. They tweeted it on Twitter. Like, it was an announcement by Israeli officials.
The Israelis say that last night's bomb explosion in the hospital in Gaza
wasn't their fault. And what do you think?
Right. I'll tell you why it's a lie. For 2 days, Israel had...
I've seen no proof of what this man is saying, by the way.
What do you think?
Right. I'll tell you why it's a lie. For 2 days, Israel had been saying, and saying for the hospital workers, we are going to bomb you. For 2 days, they have been saying we're going to bomb you. So it's...
Is there any proof of that? You don't have to do any Google searching or anything, but this is like out of left field. Is there any proof of that?
Within the same framework.
Well, things are changing. Yeah. Things are changing.
Way? In what way?
In many ways. Worldwide is changing. Israel is weaker. The United States is weaker. The Mukawama, the resistance, is actually stronger.
No, I know. And this is a complete misconception that, you know, that Hamas can just like tough it out. Eventually we're going to win if we just, you know, stick around and live in the rubble. Israel has the power, and quite frankly, Israel can get away with geopolitically can get away with exiling a million fucking Gazans into the southern part of Gaza. They can get away with that. Okay, yeah, the United States is going to, you know, wring their hands. And yes, the United Nations is going to wring their hands. But at the end of the day, all the big players are going to sing Israel's tune. And, you know, and they're just going to, you know, condemn. They'll make a lot of verbal condemnations. But at the end of the day, Israel will be able to get away with this. The only thing that can stop this is with a real, honest to God, political fucking movement of the Palestinians pushing back against, you know, the West, against the occupation, but also against rockets and violence as a response to this. And yes, of course, Palestine has the right to defend itself with violence if necessary, but the power dynamic is so overwhelming. It's so overwhelming. We need to hit, you got to hit that chalkboard again. You got to hit the drawing board again. We gotta try some Gandhi, all right? Enough Malcolm X. We gotta give Gandhi a shot. And it sounds desperate, and it's, look, man, if I was in that shit, I'd probably be picking up a gun too. But it's not gonna work. Every time Hamas does something, it fuels Israel's fire. It gives them the ability to commit more atrocities. It gives them more cover. Hamas's barbarity gives Israel more cover. And I've talked about this months ago, saying the exact thing that Bibi Netanyahu wants is a big attack from Hamas or from the PLO or whatever it is. That's the exact thing that he wanted. He got exactly what he wanted. We have to ask ourselves if the people representing us are giving our enemy everything that they want, how effective are they actually in helping us achieve our goals? And how come that conversation isn't happening internally in Palestine? Maybe it is. Maybe people are at coffee shops being like, you know what? This Hamas shit really isn't working out. Maybe that is happening. I just haven't seen any evidence of it.
And in time, the Israelis know they are going to lose.
But where is this heading?
So obviously the first thing is there needs to be a ceasefire, but there can't be any conversation of a ceasefire without it lifting the siege on Gaza, yeah. And without a conversation about a Palestinian state. The Palestinian state should be, as this brilliant man just said, it should be from the river to the sea. And what that means is not that that we're throwing the Jews into the river, as Zionist propaganda would have you believe. Yeah. What that means is there needs to be one state that is secular for people of all religions, because that is what Palestine was before the Zionist entity.
But do you really?
Yeah, so it's exactly what I'm talking about, is that Israel needs to look at the 1967 proposal. There's a corridor for the West Bank and Gaza. The PLO, the Palestinian Authority, has accepted that they're never going to get all of Palestine back. They've accepted that. Yeah, I ban Jim Moneymaker? Didn't I have to ban you? Why are you back? And why are you telling me this? Should I just ban you immediately? What is this? Is this some kind of power move? Like it's like I'm supposed to be impressed that you can go to the login screen of Twitch and create a new account in 5 seconds? Am I supposed to be fucking intimidated by this? All right, I didn't ban you. Okay, Jim. I know we've butted heads, but I wasn't sure if I actually banned you or not. Welcome back. Thank you for being here. God, I'm a great host.
I think that is a viable possibility under these circumstances.
It's the only possibility.
Despite all of the carnage, we have seen an example of the Palestinians pushing back and the resistance of the Palestinians push. Technically true,
but wow, guys, pretty fucking counterproductive to literally give BB and Ben exactly what they want. Literally exactly what, I mean, they couldn't have asked for more, for a better propaganda tool than the videos of children being, you know, slaughtered. They couldn't ask for more. Almost like Hamas is, I mean, like, honestly, it's like, is Hamas working for these assholes? You're like, it's like they're working in tandem.
The cause back to the forefront. And I will tell you that despite all of the killings that Israel is doing and trying to subjugate the population, it's causing one thing, which is an additional determination, an additional sumud, that we can liberate our country and we can make sure that the Palestinians have equal rights, the same as an American, the same as a British person, the same as an Israeli person.
And J.K. Rowling is a turf.
In the sound and fury of today, it is hard to imagine any compromise, any solution.
No need to hate her for being a woman.
But the status quo is equally unbearable. We drive back to East Jerusalem through a landscape scarred by walls and defined by mistrust. To catch up with a gathering of Christian leaders here, their robes a reminder of the ancient claims of religion on this patch of earth.
And we are against any violence against any civilian or innocent people.
Their presence here to support the Anglican owners of the stricken hospital in Gaza, in unyielding unity, they denounce what they call a military crime.
It was 500 casualties. Right. That's the number we received. We saw in the news, all over the news, and we know from what we have seen in cameras, they've been...
There 500 casualties is has to be an overestimation. Either they were like literally standing shoulder to shoulder in that one specific spot, like waiting for an alien invasion or something, or these numbers are incorrect. There's no flipping way there was 500 people in that area, in that parking lot. No flipping way.
Hundreds of casualties there, like we could see that and we know that.
But you've not been able to verify that number independently?
No, okay. We don't have the means to do that.
Claim and counterclaim in a landscape of lies and loathing. Getting the facts right is tricky enough, but the real challenge is to find some common humanity. We'll be back from Jerusalem in a minute, but let's go back to Krishnan in London. Krishnan.
Thanks, Matt. Well, joining me here in the studio
is
Zippy Hotter.
Okay. I straight up disagree with literally everything that comes out of this woman's mouth. I'm not going to sit here and call out every dishonest debate tactic, every bad actor tactic. I'm not going to sit here and call every single thing out. You'll be able to see it on my face that I disagree with her. Just know that I see every technique, every dishonest tactic. I'm going to try to keep the pausing down to three. I'm only going to pause this segment three times. That's it, okay? But let me tell you something. I'm a little teapot short and stout, okay? This is my handle. This is my spout. I'm going to get all steamed up, and you're going to hear me shout, okay? I don't like this woman. I think she's extremely dishonest, and I think she's incredibly callous to the civilian deaths with her constant whataboutism. Her constant whataboutism. Welcome back, SBJS. I'm going to play this in its entirety. This is going to be very difficult for me to play this in its entirety. I disagree with everything this woman... I mean, there are some things I disagree with because she's twisting the facts, okay? But she's coming from a very, very dishonest place. She's clearly a bad actor. She's clearly biased. And honestly, she supports this, you know, this takeover, these settlements. She supports all of this. So only three times, okay? Be prepared. Be prepared to be pissed.
Oh. In it, but let's go back to Krishnan in London. Krishnan.
Thanks, Matt. Well, joining me here in the studio is Zippy Hotavelli.
Fatah, you're wrong. Jim Moneymaker, you're 100% incorrect. Israel has, in fact, never acknowledged the existence of the Palestinian country. Never. They've only acknowledged the existence of the PLO as a negotiator. They have never accepted Palestine's existence. So no, Israel has not been generally more honest. The PLO has at multiple times agreed to not only the 1967 borders, but even more restrictive borders that have split the West Bank into a bunch of different, you know, little fiefdoms. They've agreed to allow that to continue. If they could just stop the bloodshed, get a corridor between the West Bank and Gaza, get some fishing and allowed to function as a country, if they could just be left alone. So no, Israel has not generally been more honest in negotiations. That's a fucking lie. All right. Three pauses. Let's do this.
Let's go back to Krishnan in London. Krishnan.
Thanks, Matt. Well, joining me here in the studio is Zippy Hotoveli, the Israeli ambassador to the United Kingdom. The US president, your most important ally, was there in Israel today, cautioning you as a nation not to be consumed by rage. How do you respond to that?
Well, first of all, we had a very successful visit of President Biden in Israel, showing solidarity with the Israeli people, speaking very clearly about Israel's right for self-defense and about the fact that Israel must finish the mission of making sure Hamas capabilities will be destroyed.
Impossible.
So we stand in the same line, together with the Americans, together with the UK government, together with a big coalition of international leaders that support Israel's right, not just to self-defense, but actually they stand aligned with our mission. The mission is to make sure Hamas won't exist on our southern border, because Hamas is dangerous, both to Israelis and Palestinians.
Well, that comes to the other very important thing that the president said.
Literally impossible.
It's important to have achievable objectives. There are many people in Israel and outside who believe the idea of making Hamas not exist is not an achievable objective. Why do you think it is? You know, how do you erase Hamas when there are generations?
Krishnan, it's very simple. Think about ISIS gets into your doorstep in London. This is the reality that Israel was facing.
I understand
facing.
The desire, but the Wait question a second, is whether it's achievable. Can I ask you something?
He's going to push back on this ISIS canard.
The answer is yes.
Has it been erased? Absolutely not.
No, but ISIS as a movement that killed innocent people in masses was destroyed by the Americans and other countries.
The fuck it was.
That's a very debatable.
So, the fuck it was.
What happened
today,
to those people? And what's happened? It's not the entity it was in Iraq at that point. But has it been destroyed? Has it gone away? Big question.
So look,
and the same thing applies to Hamas as to whether you can really destroy it.
I will give you an answer. So Hamas is three levels. One level is.
This pause doesn't count. It's a response to Clutch Cargo. I do acknowledge that, yes, there have been times that the Palestinian Authority hasn't been on. And you'll see me. I'm happy to criticize the Palestinian Authority for its corruption and anti-democratic nature. I don't think it's representing the Palestinians very well either. And I do agree that at times they have been bad actors. But if you look at the totality of these negotiations, there has been capitulation by the PLO and other entities that represented the Palestinian people before the PLO, the Palestinian Authority, was a thing. Look at the history of negotiations. No, Israel has not been an honest actor in this. But yes, no, the Palestinian Authority has not been squeaky clean on this either. I do agree.
I will give you an answer. So,
but has it been destroyed? Has it gone away? Big question.
So look,
and the same thing applies to Hamas as to whether you can really destroy it.
I will give you an answer. So Hamas is three levels. One level is military capabilities. I hope we all agree that Israel must destroy those capabilities, because at the moment, as we speak, Israel...
So that hospital that was bombed before this other hospital that was bombed by who knows who, but the hospital that was confirmed to be bombed... Right. Well, because what they say is that, well, Hamas launches rockets from literally anywhere. Right. So it's like, well, we can attack anywhere we want. Schools, hospitals, mosques. It does not matter. And Hamas does fire rockets from mosques, from schools, from hospitals. Right. Knowing that those targets are going to be a bigger PR disaster for Israel to strike. They knowingly use those resources for that purpose. Okay, that's one pause.
Israel is under a rocket attack. Israel went through the worst rocket attack in the last few days. So we have over 6,000 rocket attacks in Tel Aviv, in Jerusalem.
How many actually
we have
hit?
Parliament being evacuated. We have people still 100? In shelters as okay, we speak.
A couple
so this
hundred?
This is the way things are. So it means we need to dismantle.
These
Hamas
are nasty rockets, though. These are not
this
the rockets of old.
There is a second layer, which
they're
is
deadly rockets.
Hamas leadership. Hamas leadership calculately made this barbaric massacre at the 7th of October and still holding
undeniable.
Hostage 199 innocent
yeah,
children.
I understand innocent, why you want to get
can,
them.
Can I ask you something? Why
the question
are you
is whether you can what, do it.
Why?
Yeah.
Yeah. The answer is yes. The answer is we must. And we have the backup of the international community. But I want to tell you something. As we speak, Hamas is still holding hostage these people. So yeah. I want sensitivity to the humanitarian case of our hostages.
I want sensitivity. You're bombing the shit out of them. You're bombing the shit out of the hostages.
Of demanding that. International community should stand with Israel yeah. on this humanitarian
case. And you can see
case.
That they are not going to be released as long as you are bombing Gaza.
This is exactly what Hamas...
It's not going to happen, is it?
This is the equation Hamas wants to create. But
okay, this is the equation Hamas wants to create. Hamas doesn't create equations. Okay, no, this is the reality of the situation. They're not going to fucking come to the negotiating table, you know, while you're bombing the shit out of them. You're like, no, that's an equation Hamas has invented. What are you talking? What does that even mean? That's the reality of the situation. They're not going to come and negotiate with you while you're bombing them.
Gaza.
This is exactly what Hamas...
It's not going to happen, is it?
I got one more.
Hamas wants to create. But I want to tell you clearly, Israel won't hold itself to defend its people. This is a war of defense.
Thank you,
David.
We
have no other aims. I mean, Israel went back to the international border in 2005. So we didn't have to deal with Gaza, but they wanted to destroy Israel. So they started a war.
You kept occupying them. You put up a wall and denied all kinds of medicine and food.
The question is whether you can do that.
There's a full-blown apartheid. Oh, we left them alone in 2005. Lies.
Israel has killed two or three times.
Everyone agrees this should be.
Lies.
The question is whether you can do that without massive, massive civilian casualties. Already, Israel has killed two or three times as many Palestinians in its bombing, Palestinian children, Palestinian women, as were killed in the Hamas attack.
So just
that can only, and you haven't even begun yet. You haven't even begun the ground war. So the question is, are you really talking about erasing a people here when you're talking about erasing Hamas? You know, where do you draw the distinction between Hamas fighters and ordinary families?
It's so clear for us that the moral values of Israel are so clear. We never target civilians.
But you kill them.
No.
You don't may not target them, but you do
so,
kill them.
So I will tell you something about that. Just yesterday, we were witnessing, I think this is actually, if we take that as a microcosmos of the problem, it will be easier. The fact that the media was reporting
you,
about this bombing of the hospital, blaming Israel, zero responsibility
for an
accurate report. The fact that 3 hours later, we were delivering accurate message. The fact wait a second.
All of that is disputed. I mean,
Krishna,
you can say it's
accurate,
but
can I tell you something?
There is
if
another
you want
version.
To listen, then you need to give me to portray the whole picture because this is a complicated conflict, right? So we need to understand what Israel was going.
All right, it's my last one. The Israeli talking heads demand to have dominance over the narrative. They demand their version of reality can be the only reality. There is no pushback on it. And I'm really, really sick and tired of this. Like, no, you need to understand that this is the reality that we've made. This is how things are. I mean, and from their perspective, the occupation isn't happening. Palestine is allowed to live in peace. They're just minding their own business. Meanwhile, the reality is every single week, there's a new settlement being created. There's families getting kicked out of their homes in the West Bank. There's violence in the Gaza Strip from the IDF every single day. And the reality that Israel has conjured, nope, doesn't exist. We can do no wrong. And if we ever do wrong, it's actually fully justified because of the Holocaust or fill in the blank with, you know, whatever crime Hamas has done in the last, you know, 20, 30 years, whatever.
going through. So we checked our intelligence. We were actually bringing to the table all the evidence that not just that Israel didn't do it, we showed to the world a phone call between two terrorists in Gaza.
Welcome, Trailhead.
Saying, wait a second, saying nothing is questionable because we've seen both the British and the American accept the fact it was 100% Israel didn't do it. So you had the jihadic
that
Islam.
That call is disputed.
The jihadic Islam.
There are many people who say Krishna. This is not authentic.
Krishnan, I want to tell you something. There is a massive difference.
I want to tell you something. I want to talk over you.
Airstrike.
I need to talk over you.
On the ground, you could see the hospital was there. It was a rocket attack, clearly.
You cannot see the rocket. You cannot see the rocket land on the hospital in that video.
You can see the parking lot.
You can see an explosion in the air, and then you can see an explosion on the ground. You cannot prove that those two things were linked. There may have been other ordnance involved.
I will tell you what is a proof. We have a segment of our intelligence recording Hamas terrorists saying, this is a jihadic Islam rocket.
Well, as I say,
this is exactly what I'm saying.
It's disputed by them, and
it's disputed by experts, actually.
That doesn't sound real.
It's more reasonable.
Yeah, no, there are people in the region that said that doesn't sound right. That doesn't sound like a Palestinian accent.
I'm not just saying it's Hamas alone, but there are other people who have said that tape is disputed. And not, I can't say it's true or not true, but all I'm saying
is I will tell you something.
It is disputed.
The intelligence services.
And all the evidence that you've presented is disputed, as is theirs.
So I will tell you something. The intelligence services, both us and the Americans, thought it was credible. And this is why President Biden said
very clearly...
The
Americans are your closest allies. It'd be extraordinary if they rejected
your... So you think basically Hamas is more reliable than Americans?
No, but I'm saying the fact that the Americans support...
Listen to yourself.
...does not necessarily mean it's true.
But this is a microcosmos of the fact. And there is a matter of a fact, 30% of the rockets fall in the land of Gaza. So it means basically they don't care killing their own children.
But can I ask you something?
Why are you not taking a moral statement here to say you don't care about your own people by firing your rockets?
We'll see. I'm on the fence.
Of them land up in Gaza and end up killing civilians.
Well, you can take that moral position, but that's not for me.
Are basically, they don't care about human.
Pausing to respond to Clutch Cargo. That's a very, very complicated subject. Famously, Star Trek had to cut a segment out of an episode when Data pointed out that a lot of successful political revolutions were triggered by violence and the death of civilians. And it had to be cut in Ireland for obvious reasons. So that is a very complicated topic. With that said, I've made it very clear that is not the case in this scenario. If Hamas churns up the violence, it is not going to stop Israel. It is not going to inspire the Western alliance that supports Israel to stop supporting Israel. No matter how brutal Hamas gets, they could be lopping the heads off of children every single day, and that is not going to stop the Western alliance support of Israel. The only thing that can stop it is a change of tactics. Like I've said, I think they need to drop the Malcolm X and start embracing Gandhi. And I know that's a very privileged thing for me to say, Mr. Comfortable, sitting in a nice, you know, comfortable house that isn't being bombed, for me to say, you know, you got to stop fighting back in the way that you're fighting back. You need to change your strategies. But I do honestly believe it, that if the Palestinian people do not make a change to their strategy, start asking, you know, start making pleas for the moral high ground, start rejecting terrorism. I do think Israel will complete this project of the complete erasure of the Palestinian country. Eventually, it will happen unless the Palestinian people change their strategies and honestly stop acquiescing, silently acquiescing to Hamas, the people that are doing that. And of course, stop outwardly supporting Hamas and the like. At the same time, if I was a prisoner and some neo-Nazi was beating up my prison guard, I might cheer that guy on as he's beating the shit out of the prison guard that's been abusing me every day of my life. There are 15-year-old Palestinian teenagers that have only known Israeli oppression. That's a fact.
Rights, and they don't care about the fact at the moment Hamas is committing horrible war crimes, and you cannot ignore that.
But what I'm asking you to do is respond, because you've often said, as a human being, as a mother, you know, you want to think about the Israeli victims. Equally, as a human being and as a mother, you must want to respond to those Palestinian children.
Yes, I can. I can even
who are being killed by Israeli bombs.
Can I speak to a Palestinian woman now? I want to tell Palestinian women, Hamas is preventing you to get to a safe place. Israel, for the last 48 hours, created a shelter, created a place in southern Gaza. You can go there. It's Hamas that is spreading propaganda against Israelis and basically preventing from you to get to a safe
place. I haven't heard of this safe place.
The children of Kfar Aza and Sderot didn't get this opportunity. They were slaughtered in their homes and their beds.
So you are expelling people from their homes.
You get at the moment... Excuse me.
There is a phrase for that.
Over 100,000 Israelis don't live in their homes at the moment. Do you know that? In the north, in the south, there are refugees in their homes. So how do you call that? You call that
there
a war.
There are refugees,
you call
sure.
that a war.
There are refugees on both sides. So anything goes.
No, what I'm trying to say, Hamas started this war. There is a very, very clear story here. It's not a complexity to understand. Hamas committed the horrible crimes and atrocities, and this is why Israel must defend.
I agree,
there is a complexity, as you know, because it goes back years.
No. That's the mistake. You think it's an Israel-Palestine issue.
I need to pause to respond to Fathad here, Mr. Jim Moneymaker. None of that is justification for an apartheid against another country. I do agree. Look, Israel has a right to defend itself from terrorism. They have a right even to, you know, if they see terrorism in Palestine, right, to go after the Hamas people. I would probably even agree with that if this was very targeted and very concentrated towards actual terrorists. None of this, even if it's true or untrue, that still does not give Israel the justification to do what it's doing to the Palestinian people. Right. It we wouldn't have we're scared of drugs and weapons and rapists coming over from Mexico. It would not be justified for the United States to occupy and implement an apartheid system in Mexico because, well, that's the only way to stop the drugs and the rapists from coming over here is we have to occupy Mexico. That is not justified. All right, there are political solutions to these problems, and God damn it, we're not going to find a solution at the barrel of a gun.
Because it goes back years.
No. That's the mistake. You think it's an Israel-Palestine issue? No, it's not. Hamas is committed.
Let's go back to the question here.
Understand, Hamas committed the horrible crimes and atrocities, and this is why Israel must defend its
people.
There
is a complexity, as you know, because it goes back years.
No. That's the mistake. You think it's an Israel-Palestine issue? No, it's not. Hamas is committed to a jihad.
Trailhead, you're correct.
They want to erase Israel from the map. Hamas doesn't want a political solution. Hamas is not interested in any type of political solution. And basically, if
that's
you
technically
read
its charter, but so is Israel.
Is a genocide in the Jewish people in their homeland. And this is what people realize when they saw this horrible atrocities on Saturday, the 7th of October.
Ambassador, thank you very much indeed for joining us again in the studio.
Thank you.
Boo. I've paused enough. You've heard my opinions. Fucking boo, dude. Boo. I will be eventually playing some PS3 games. I'm going to be getting into my PS3 library and playing them, so you can look forward to that. But right now, the I'm going to be expanding the underground, right? It'll be like the video game underground. We have the news underground right here. So I'll be expanding that. But right now, I got a new kid here. I got job stuff. I got too much stuff going on for me to do anything other than what's important, which is political activism right now. But thank you for asking, Ben Tao.
Now, from Beirut to Amman, from Turkey to Iran,
boomer.
Crowds have taken to the streets, besieging embassies, hurling stones, and blaming Israel for the strike on the hospital.
I love all
Gaza.
Video games.
According to the Jordanian Foreign Ministry, an already highly volatile region is now being pushed to the brink. Our international editor, Lindsay Hilsum, has this.
Supporters of different Palestinian factions came
so
out
true,
on the streets
rebel.
Of Beirut
so true.
Today to protest Israel's campaign in Gaza. Inflamed by the news of the explosion at the hospital. They're never going to believe Israel's version of events. The security forces responded with tear gas and water cannon to keep the protesters away from the US embassy. Lebanon's precarious government fears unrest getting out of control.
Nice collection.
Earlier, the militant group Hezbollah organized a separate demonstration. They're controlled by Iran, which can decide at any time whether to open up a new front against Israel.
Thank you, Clutch.
Yesterday, five Hezbollah fighters were killed in an exchange of fire with the Israeli Defense Forces across the border, a warning that this war could yet escalate and expand. At the Organization of Islamic Cooperation meeting in Jeddah, Iran made its support for Hamas clear.
I express condolences to the Palestinian people and the resistance, and emphasize that this crime is being committed as the Zionist entity collapses, which happened on Saturday, October the 7th.
Whataboutism is not going to create a resolution. You know what I mean? Whataboutism from Israel and whataboutism from people who represent Palestine. We are not ever, ever, ever going to get to a resolution if we are constantly justifying the brutality and the violence that both sides are committing. Each side needs to, step one, acknowledge the crimes that have been committed. And the reason, and the, frankly, the reason why both sides are not accepting the reality is because they don't, you know, they want to win. They don't want to work together. They want to destroy one another and be on top, and, you know, be on top of the ash heap.
With the great resistance operation. But the United States is trying to revive the collapsed Zionist entity by conducting a war against civilians.
The Saudis, previously collapsed on the brink of a deal with Israel,
Israel is absolutely having a full-blown democratic crisis with what Bibi Netanyahu has done to the judiciary. Collapsed? Not on Sleepy Joe Biden's watch.
Careful to distinguish between Hamas and the Palestinian people.
The latest painful developments show that the international community should act responsibly and ensure the protection of
Drink responsibly, folks. Drink responsibly.
Commit to international and humanitarian law without selectivity or double standards.
Security forces protected the Israeli embassy in Jordan, another country which saw demonstrations today. An Israeli ground invasion of Gaza.
That's not an excuse to give up hope, Trailhead. But it is important to acknowledge everyone's capability for violence, and the fact that every United States, Israel, Palestine, Hamas, the PLO, and yes, there is some responsibility for the Palestinian people who are acquiescing to these entities that are representing them. There's blood on everyone's hands, man. We, you know, there's still blood on American citizens' hands from Viet fucking Nam. And good luck getting an average American admitting that we lost the Vietnam War.
Might trigger far larger protests and risk destabilizing the region.
Well, earlier I spoke to Osama Hamdan. He's a
same rule here. We're going to hear right off the bat this person representing Palestine deny the brutality, deny the violence. You've already heard my opinions on this, how I think it damages the Palestinian people. I'm only going to pause three times, okay? I disagree with a lot of what this guy said. I disagree with this guy less, but right off the bat, you're going to deny the atrocities, and what about oppression? You are ruining the Palestinian people's opportunity for a moral high ground to say, like, no, we're better than that. The Palestinian people are better than Hamas. Of course they don't support Hamas. Yes, there are extremists and there are people, radicals, and people, you know, just like in every country, there are extremists and radicals that agree with violence. But no, a majority of the Palestinian people do not agree with violence, and they just want peace. They just want peace. You can say all that, but you can also acknowledge the brutality of Hamas. Okay, only pausing three times. Let's do it. You're gonna get pissed off too, man. It's like, you know, this is not Ukraine, Russia over here. You know, where is Zelensky? I need my Zelensky bay, dude. You know how Zelensky comes out and says something, and you're like, fuck yeah, dude, fucking blasting, dude. You know, dick rock hard, right? You know how he does that? And then, like, this is just like fucking, you know, I'm in Leviathan from the painkiller fucking movies, dude. I'm in absolute hell.
The spokesman based in Beirut for Hamas. I asked him for his reaction Great to point, the Israeli Rebel. Assertion that Hamas, not Israel, is to blame for the strike on the hospital.
Well, and the Israelis are still lying. They have lied the first day by saying women and children were beheaded. And now they are lying by saying that the hospital was...
I haven't seen the video. God damn it, I already paused. This one doesn't count. I haven't seen the video, but there, I'm seeing a lot of pushback. I don't know, Davey, if you've been watching videos of children getting their heads cut off, not because you enjoy it, but so that you could see the proof of it. I haven't seen the confirmation, right? But I've seen a lot of people say that there are videos out there, but full disclosure, I have not seen kids getting their heads lopped off on video. I haven't seen that. And I also haven't seen picture evidence of like that happening in a kibbutz, you know, like the Israeli police, you know, taking pictures of these massacres happening in these border towns. I haven't seen any picture evidence of that either, of a like an infant being decapitated. So I don't know on that one.
And the Israelis are still lying. They have lied the first day by saying women and children were beheaded. And now they are lying by saying that the hospital was attacked by Islamic Jihad. A few minutes after the hospital was bombed, an army spokesperson said that we warned them and some other five hospitals to evacuate, but they didn't done that. So they tried to change the story after 2 hours by saying this hospital was used by some militants from Hamas. Mm. But at the moment when the hospital was bombed, for more than 20 minutes before that,
I've
more
seen
than
those videos,
30 minutes
Davey.
After that, there was no alert in Israel. There was no alarm. That means either their radars were not working, which is not true, or they are lying, which is the fact. So they have to admit that.
I'm sorry. Okay, first pause. No, Hamas disabled a lot of these alarms. Okay, and some of them did work, some of them did go off, but they were all you know, some of the first attacks were on these border bases, and they were running skeleton crews. I mean, there's literally video of them, a first person video of Hamas slaughtering these, you know, Israeli border guards that were completely, I mean, literally caught in their underwear. It just had just enough time to throw in a flak vest before they got shot up.
They have bombed the hospital, and they bombed that on purpose because in the last 12 days before bombing the hospital, they attacked 57 medical centers.
It's true.
57.
Mm. That's probably
lying,
true.
And they have to admit that they have done
the 57
crime,
probably isn't true. It's probably too high, but they did bomb medical facilities.
Okay, so you're saying that they're lying, and they're saying that you're lying about this specific attack. And one of the bits of evidence they produced today in the press conference, this is the IDF I'm talking about, was an intercept of a conversation between Islamic Jihad and Hamas commanders,
where
they more
or less
admitted
that
they made a mistake.
Yep.
Again, are you saying that that's just fabrication, or is that something that you take seriously?
No, this is, well, it's not a conversation. It's a fake conversation.
Let me just, the reason why
literally,
we're
almost
here,
literally says
the reason
it.
Why you're talking to me, is still because of the events that happened on the October the 7th. Now, I spoke to Israeli first responders yesterday. These are the people who go in and they discover the bodies. It's a charity, it's volunteer work. And the scenes of brutality, of the aftermath of slaughter of innocent civilians that they
Video
describe
evidence.
Are profoundly shocking.
Video
disemboweling,
evidence.
Disemboweling, in some cases, few cases, beheading, the burning of children, their hands tied behind their backs. What is your response to these appalling acts?
So I haven't seen video of the beheadings, and he's all doubtful about that. I have seen picture evidence of children's hands bound behind their backs, and I have seen evidence of children's corpses burned. Of course, what do you think his response is going to be?
Of slaughter that were carried out by your men.
Well, I believe they are lying. This is a big lie
Fuck
created
you.
By them.
Fuck
they
you, dude.
They built this country on the blood of the Palestinians. They have to remember...
Yeah, Trailhead, 100%.
Excuse me.
Let's set aside the rhetoric
Excuse
for one side.
No,
there
I
are
can't
pictures,
put
there are photographs.
Aside.
There is documentary evidence. Are you saying that they staged all this?
Excuse me.
Ignore. Narrative. Pile drive my narrative.
They are lying all the time. Why to believe them today?
Do you regret the slaughter of Israeli civilians? Because many people I've spoken to here...
Don't believe your lying eyes. Bullshit.
October the 7th has set your cause...
We have video. We have pictures.
You are not getting my point. I'm not talking about history. I'm talking
about...
Oh,
please, Davey. God, these people.
I am telling you that they were lying all the time. I don't buy it now. I will not buy it.
Deny it all. Fuck you, dude.
Okay. President Mahmoud Abbas, the head of the Palestinian Authority, has called on Hamas to release the hostages, the 190 or so hostages. Why don't you release
Ukraine
them?
Hasn't stopped fighting.
I did.
Sorry to interrupt the question here. Ukraine hasn't stopped fighting.
President Mahmoud Abbas, the head of the Palestinian Authority, has called on Hamas to release the hostages, the 190 or so hostages. Why don't you release them?
I didn't hear that from President Abbas.
But why don't you just release the hostages? It would be the humane thing to do.
There is no hostages.
Fuck you, journalist.
There is war prisoners.
They're prisoners of war.
There is foreigners.
They're innocent civilians, most of them. There are soldiers, but many of them, scores of them are innocent civilians.
If someone...
He's saying there's no innocent civilians?
The pictures of civilians, yes.
I'm sorry, a pause, but he's saying no innocent civilians? There's literally video of Hamas that Hamas put out video showing like a whole fucking warehouse filled with like 30 women and children, dude. They've shown individual women. There was one just, was it yesterday of an Israeli woman? You know, it must have been 19 or 20. Fake news. How in the world am as a leftist am I supposed to come to the defense of this shit, of this dishonest nonsense? This person's supposed to be representing the Palestinians' best interests. I fucking doubt it. Just deny what we see, whether it's all staged or what, you know, it's all lies. Oh yeah, Israel super technology. Everything's all lies. Everything we do is good. Everything they do bad. Really? We're still there?
Innocent civilians, most of them. There are soldiers, but many of them, scores of them are innocent civilians.
If someone
innocent civilians.
Killing me.
We saw the pictures of civilians yesterday.
Taking my lands.
Okay.
Taking my lands. Mm. I will resist.
The Israelis say they want to eliminate Hamas.
That's a justified response to occupation.
Hamas, who is going to run the Gaza Strip?
To actually resist.
Well, they have said that.
Sorry, I'm interrupting the question.
The Israelis say they want to eliminate Hamas. If and when they eliminate Hamas, who is going to run the Gaza Strip?
Well, they have said that before, several times. They couldn't do that. The main problem is the occupation. The resistance will be continued unless the occupation is ended.
True.
Okay, we're going to leave it there. Osama Hamdan, thank you very much.
True.
Thank you.
The falsehood that if Israel were to dare to give Palestine their autonomy back, that Israel that Palestine would become more powerful and attempt a siege or an invasion of Israel is a complete made up fabrication. And honestly, it does not matter, because a country should be allowed to be autonomous to make that decision. You can't have one country just saying, well, there's a chance that this hypothetical might come true, so we get to dominate you because of this hypothetical that we've created. You know, we're scared of this hypothetical, so we get to do whatever we want to your country and its people. That is not a justification for an apartheid or occupation. Yeah, Davey, I don't believe it that if Palestine, the Palestinian people and the Palestinian, you know, authority or whatever government is actually, you know, comes out of this, if they were treated with respect on the international stage, regardless of whether you're correct or whether I'm correct, Palestine deserves an opportunity to do that. It is immoral, and it is disgusting for another country to make that decision for that country based off its xenophobic and racist fears. It says, I am too scared of your religion and your people to give you autonomy to make your own decisions. So regardless of whether you're correct, Davey, that, oh, yeah, if we give Palestinian people autonomy, they're going to invade Israel and take it over. Whether you're correct or whether I'm correct, that if we give them a chance on the international stage, they would start running their affairs like a real country. Whether you're correct or whether I'm correct, Palestine deserves the right to make that decision. Palestine deserves the right to make that wrong decision if they decide to invade Israel at that point. But quite frankly, Palestine hasn't had the opportunity to have an opinion since the fucking Nakba, since the start of all of this.
Now, I've also been speaking to the United States Congressman Seth Moulton, who's an Iraq war veteran, and I began by asking him about President Biden's wording that last night's hospital blast was committed by the other team and why he might have said that.
Well, he would say that if he has convincing evidence that that's the case, and we've heard these reports. I cannot tell you at this moment that that's been confirmed, but I'm expecting to get a classified briefing myself shortly. Where we hope to get to the bottom of what happened that led to this devastating loss of life.
So has he seen anything that hasn't been presented to the public?
You're dead wrong, Davey. I disagree with you vehemently.
I guarantee you he has. American intelligence.
Anything
that led to this devastating loss of life.
So has he seen anything that hasn't been presented to the public by the IDF, by the Israeli army?
I guarantee he has. American intelligence is watching the situation unfold very carefully here. And
I mean, regardless of whether Davey's, fear and xenophobia of the Palestinian people is correct or whether I'm correct that they deserve autonomy, the Palestinian country deserves autonomy. They deserve an opportunity to make that mistake, you know? They deserve that opportunity to represent themselves independently in the geopolitical stage. And then, if there's a full-blown invasion of Israel, the Israeli military and the United States and the Western alliance would be fully justified in pushing back against the Palestinian military. It'd be a fully justified war if Palestine attempted an invasion of Israel. But Palestine deserves an opportunity to make those mistakes, to this idea that Israel has the right to preemptively oppress a country because they're afraid of a theoretical hypothetical is absolutely fucking ridiculous.
And although we have intelligence sharing with the Israelis, we also have just
it's
our
ridiculous.
Own intelligence that we gather.
And nobody would apply this logic to any other country or any other situation that a country is justified in preemptively occupying another country because it's afraid of some hypothetical that it's created. No other situation would this even be a fucking debate
on the situation as it's going on. And the president sounded quite confident that he has seen some of that classified information. Obviously, this will be one of the first questions that we ask when we go into this congressional classified briefing for the House Armed Services Committee in a few minutes.
It's extremely rare for an American
Clutch,
president
I don't support
to
Hamas,
fly
and I don't think Hamas is doing a good job governing.
For the House Armed Services Committee in a few minutes.
It's extremely rare for an American president to fly into a hot situation like this one in Israel.
Big time damage control.
In the middle of a conflict. Do you think that this day trip has been worth it?
I think that's the kind of leadership that President Biden is showing the rest of the world. There's a lot of criticism of America right now. Some of it is well-founded. I'm standing here in the House.
Just got to respond to what I see Rebel doing in the comments section. Yes, there is oppression, but I agree with Clutch Cargo. That, you know, firing rockets and committing little mini massacres, you know, and antagonizing Israel obviously isn't working either. It literally puts logs in Bibi Netanyahu's fire. It's literally exactly the propaganda tool that Bibi and Ben need to finish this project to destroy Palestine. So it should not be defended, Rebel, by just saying oppression, oppression, oppression. People like us, Rebel, need to acknowledge the failure of Hamas as a governing body and, of course, as a strategy against oppression. We need to acknowledge that and not defend it. Davey, I mean, look, if that is the compromise that needs to be made to create peace, all right, fine. Let's have that conversation. At the very least, you acknowledge that the Palestinian country deserves to exist and does deserve autonomy from the Israeli occupation so that it can make its own decisions. And quite frankly, the current configuration of the West Bank does not allow that. Israel needs to extract its settlers from the West Bank so that Palestine can actually have a legitimate country, right, in the West Bank and in the Gaza Strip, some kooky little corridor between them. But unless Israel settlers get out of the West Bank, it, in some capacity, this is a non-starter. Look at a map of the West Bank and tell me that that is somehow going to be some cohesive country with Israel carving out whole chunks of it, right? Are we just going to have borders, fences surrounding every little chunk of the West Bank, and this is supposed to be normal? Little corridors, what, little underground corridors? No, Israel needs to pull out of the parts of the West Bank so that Palestine has an honest-to-God fucking country again.
House of Representatives without a Speaker of the House. It's the first time in our nation's
Thank
history
you, Clutch,
that that's happened.
For that correction.
But there's still an awful lot of good that's coming out of America, a lot of important things, important leadership that we provide the rest of the world. And that is
Thank
what
you for that correction,
President
Rebel.
Biden is showing.
But America gives billions of dollars in financial and military aid to Egypt, for instance. The Egyptian president didn't want to meet President Biden. Surely that kind of cash at least buys you, you know, a face-to-face meeting with the Egyptian president, and it didn't happen.
Well, look, diplomacy is complicated, and it's especially complicated in the Middle East, as I learned myself, spending years there fighting as a U.S. Marine in Iraq. You can have a very close friends who say different things behind the scenes than they say in public. Obviously, the Arab leaders thought that in the wake of this tragedy at the hospital, it was important for them to show solidarity with their people who are so upset at what's going on. That doesn't mean the Egyptians aren't talking to President Biden or to the Americans or to our other allies.
But these are America's friends, Egypt and Jordan, the Palestinian Authority. The fact that you're not meeting them at all or can only meet them behind closed doors or on the telephone, it does show you the limits of American influence in this region, doesn't it?
You know, look, this is just the Good nature point. Of complex diplomacy across the globe. Mm. I think our Arab leaders felt, the Arab leaders there felt like they had to, you know, do this today. But that doesn't mean that they're not talking with us and they're not going to meet with the president at some time in the future.
As you said, you're a former serving Marine. You sit on the Armed Services Committee in Congress. Do you think that Israel's land invasion of the Gaza Strip, assuming that it still goes ahead, is a good idea?
Well, look, Israel has a right to address this threat. And part of addressing a terrorist threat is taking out the terrorists. I mean, that's part of any counterinsurgency.
It has literally never fucking worked yet. Okay? Am I literally in a fucking Rick and Morty alternate universe where the Iraq and Afghanistan wars didn't happen? You know what I mean? Have we completely rewritten the history on the war on terror and what a fucking flying failure that has been? Am I losing my fucking mind? Or was the war on terror a complete and abject failure that resulted in Americans getting killed, Iraqi, Afghanistan, civilians, all the different tribes therein? ISIS still exists. ISIL still exists. The Taliban fucking run Afghanistan. So honestly, this idea, the only way we can get terrorism is blowing them up. That's what works every time. The fuck it does. The fuck it does, man. Terrorism is the Hydra. You cut off the head and another one grows and you keep cutting those heads. Oh, we just got a Taliban leader. Remember how many Taliban fucking leaders we got every month? Oh, we got a new big high level Taliban leader. Boy, we're kicking butt. Taliban run the whole fucking country. So this lie, this straight up lie that the only way to defeat terrorism is with the barrel of a gun is fucking disgusting, dude. It's what the fuck are we talking about?
Israel has a right to address this threat. And part of addressing a terrorist threat is taking out the terrorists. I mean, that's part of any counterinsurgency campaign.
America!
What is
Israel fuck yeah!
We've but completely forgotten it. We've completely forgotten
this. One of the first terrorists. I mean, that's part of any counterinsurgency campaign, which is essentially what Israel is getting into here. But it's much more complex than that. And one of the first lessons that America learned in Iraq and Afghanistan is you have to have a plan for the day after. Simply assaulting Gaza is going to be extraordinarily difficult for the Israeli Defense Forces. I've fought in an urban environment like that. I mean, they're going to take tremendous casualties just trying to go in and kill terrorists. If they kill a lot of civilians as a byproduct of trying to take out Hamas, they're actually going to recruit more terrorists to the cause. That ultimately is counterproductive. So how Israel actually carries out this operation?
I mean, fascinating, right? Because he's towing the American, the Western narrative that the war on terror. What are you talking about? That was a big success. We defeated ISIS, and you know it wasn't that bad. We were effective in taking out these terrorist cells. It was effective. So he's saying that while also contradicting himself and saying, oh yeah, when I was a soldier, you know, tasked with taking out the terrorists. It was really hard. A lot of people got killed. It didn't really work. He can't say that part. So it's amazing to me how he has to repeat this idea that the war on terror is a possible thing. But then he also, you know, gives us a dose of reality that, oh, yeah, it was a huge clusterfuck. And, you know, it was extremely difficult. But of course, and doesn't mention the fact that he failed in his task. The United States military failed in its task to destroy terrorism in any of the places that it tried to. Can't say that part.
Take out Hamas, they're actually going to recruit more terrorists to the cause. That
acknowledging blowback
is counterproductive. So how Israel actually carries out this operation and what vision they have for
Davey,
the future
I agree.
Of Gaza, what vision the people of Gaza who don't want to support Hamas can look forward to, that is essential to their success. And I have yet to articulate, I have yet to hear them articulate what that is.
And that's crucial, isn't it? Because my question was, is it a good idea as far as we know at the moment? And what I'm hearing for you is no.
No.
No. Well, it's not that simple. Again, I mean, it is certainly a good idea to.
Yeah, it's not that simple because I got to keep my job and there's a certain line I have to toe. But I'm trying to basically play both sides and hedge my bets here so I don't look like a complete warmongering fool. But yeah, no, there is a Western line that I have to toe here. But so it's not that simple. It actually is. It actually is that simple.
Is no.
It doesn't
work.
Well,
it's not that simple. Again, I mean,
it doesn't
fucking
work.
It's a good idea to take out the terrorists who perpetrated these attacks. But that's not it. You have to have a plan for what comes next. And that's the piece that I think Israel really needs to develop.
Take out,
and they need
take
to
out
share
the
that,
terrorists.
With allies like us and you, but also with the people of Gaza. They have to paint a future that the people of Gaza can look forward to instead of supporting Hamas. That's how you ultimately.
So I do agree with that, and that's what I've been stressing throughout this entire stream.
Win this fight. General McChrystal, who's a famed American general, estimated this insurgent math, he called it, which he said was 10 to 1. For every one innocent civilian that you kill, you recruit about 10 terrorists to the cause.
Blowback.
So,
blowback.
I mean, that's tough
blowback.
Math, and that paints the picture of how difficult this operation is going to be for it.
So he says that. He says that shit while also saying, yeah, well, it's not that it's complicated. We could still achieve this at the barrel of a gun, but every time we kill an innocent civilian, which is every airstrike, we basically create 10 more terrorists. It's a little counterproductive, but we'll figure it out. We're rah rah. We're very good at this. Well, we got it all figured out. It's just, you know, just got to watch out for that. You know, meanwhile, the Israeli military is bomb everything across the entire strip, bomb checkpoints, bomb civilian areas, right? Yeah, okay, blowback. I don't give a shit. We're just going to kill everybody anyway. Okay, I'm being flippant. I'm generalizing. I'm putting words in the mouth, you know, of the Israeli government. But goddamn, man. But goddamn.
Israel.
So just in 10 seconds, by that calculation, 3,000 dead Palestinians in Gaza, most of
Thank
them
Thank you for that correction, Clutch, Rebel, and Davey.
30,000 new terrorists.
No checkpoints in the Gaza Strip.
Evidence that they're mostly civilians.
Just walls. So, I mean, this is interesting. This is like, what, you got a big slam dunk here? There's no evidence that these are mostly civilians? There's no fucking evidence that they're mostly Hamas either. And I'm really shocked that this reporter dropped the ball on this.
Palestinians in Gaza, most of them civilians, they've recruited 30,000 new terrorists, in your language.
Well, first of all, where's your evidence that they're mostly civilians?
40% of them are fucking innocent children. And yes, I still believe children are innocent, even if they're born in a Muslim environment. I still believe children are innocent.
I mean, if you're just listening to
that's according
Hamas
to the Gaza
that,
health.
I mean, Israel's trying to target Hamas.
Sorry to hear that,
Rebel. So we don't know exactly what that math is right now, but the 10-to-1 figure that I explained makes this a very, very difficult equation to be sure.
Seth Moulton, thank you very much indeed.
Man, I mean, it's just a literally a walking contradiction. This guy. Literally, yeah, blowback is a reality, and some credible people have estimated that for every civilian we kill, we create 10 terrorists, but, you know, it'll work out. We got it figured out. I mean, it's complicated. You know, Israel probably should keep up the bombing, but, you know, just target Hamas. Just stick it to Hamas. I mean, how many bombs has Israel dropped? Thousands. Fucking thousands. All right, I got about 45 minutes. We got 45 minutes left. We're going to do a three-hour stream here. So I got about 45 minutes left, and we're just going to show this clip here from Davey. Multiple camera angles. We got, welcome back, Ford the Perfect. Multiple camera angles of the Gazan hospital being bombed. Once again, officially, I'm on the fence, but I am leaning towards Israeli's narrative. Even though Israel has already bombed a hospital in this offensive and has bombed hospitals in the past, 100% fact, unquestionable fact. Regardless of those facts, right now I'm more leaning towards Israeli's narrative. With that said, this definitely does look like an airburst munition, so I'm looking forward to seeing these multiple camera angles. Let's see what this says. Hey, thank you, Lenny, for coming in. I appreciate it. Have yourself a good night. And hey, folks, make sure you're subscribing to Lenny. Check out Lenny's Twitch channel. Like and subscribe to Lenny, your boy. Thank you, Lenny. All right, so let's watch this. Ugh, CNN, but what can you do?
I do want to bring in CNN military analyst, Lieutenant General Mark Hertling, here with me at the Magic Wall. When you see...
I was going to make an old person joke, but no, that's not very nice. I just got to turn up the volume on my end here. Very quiet mix. All right, let's get back to it.
That, in isolation, one of the things we have heard repeatedly from officials that are pointing to the IDF, they say, no rocket could make an explosion that big. What do you see there?
Well, first, what I'll start off by saying, Davey, Phil, is I've heard the expression fog of war about 100 times so far this morning. Excuse me. I'm not a bomb analyst, right. Neither are you, but what you see here is a very large fiery explosion.
I don't know, guys. I don't know, guys. I might cut this video short.
That's not usually something that comes with a guided bomb from an aircraft. What it seems to be, and this is just really conjecture on my part, is a rocket that still has fuel on board. That's the indicator, the fuel propellant that pushes a rocket forward. When it hit the ground, the rocket exploded like they always do when they hit, but there was a lot of fuel in that rocket too because it had fallen out of the sky. So you see a very large blast, fiery blast in a parking lot.
So to this point.
Okay, so he's saying that he thinks it's consistent with not the warhead not exploding, but the fuel in the rocket exploding and causing that damage.
I think this has been one of the pieces of information that we've heard from IDF.
Davey, chill the fuck out. I'll watch the goddamn clip.
Officials and their view or their the evidence they're presenting, mm-hmm. which the President Biden, seems to agree with at this point, and that is what you're saying right now, the trajectory, right? What they're showing based on their radar footage, these are rocket launches or rocket strikes headed towards Israel, and this is where the hospital was. So the idea that this was a malfunction of some sort, how often does that happen? Is that something that happens with regularity?
With the kind of rockets that Hamas has or the Jihadist Union has, yes, it happens a lot. They are shipped primarily from Iran. They're not good rockets. They're four different types. They go different distances.
This is all
true. There are a lot of rocket failures, and Israel has said they have seen a lot of rocket failures, over 400 of them so far. So when you see one fall out of the sky like that, it's because the engine cuts off. They are not precision rockets. They're fired out of the back of literally a box.
Fire and
so
forget.
In this particular one, you see a series of rockets coming out of a point of origin. That's where the rockets allegedly were fired from. There are about six or seven lines. That means they're going in different trajectories. This is the one that's right over the hospital. And there's another film of a rocket going up, the engine cutting off, and then seconds later, you see that explosion on the ground that you just showed.
The other issue, and I think this is one that that struck me, and because you've heard the IDF officials talk about it a lot, is the craters, right?
Yeah.
The location of where the rocket landed or where the explosion happened, and the scale of both where it hit compared to the hospital, not on the hospital directly, but also what it created or what the kind of blast radius was, compared to Israeli footage showing, you know, this is what a crater is supposed to look like in one of our strikes. This does not have that. Does that track for you?
It does.
I mean,
this is the hospital.
Okay, I have a problem with this narrative because is it totally impossible for Israel to just use a lower quality armament? You know what I mean? Like it's pretty easily faked. I don't think that's the case here, that, you know, this is some trick or something like that, because we would have evidence of that. Like, you could see the trajectories. So I don't think that's, but I also just don't think it's a very convincing argument that the only bomb Israel knows how to drop are big fat ones that kill a lot of people. Israel is absolutely capable of dropping bombs that don't destroy whole buildings. We see them knocking on the roof of buildings using explosives that don't destroy the building right away. They, you know, they knock first, expecting people to leave the building, and then they drop a J-dam that destroys the foundation and collapses the entire thing. So I'm just not convinced that the only bomb Israel knows how to drop are big fat ones, if you know what I'm saying here.
Building,
right?
As a satellite imagery. This is a parking lot. When we see the cars in that parking lot, most of them are burned, not all of them. There's not kind of the blast that you would expect from a very large bomb like that coming off.
And I've heard a different military analyst say the same thing.
An aircraft. It looks more like a lot of fire, a lot of burning, some shrapnel against the building. Again, this is the parking lot. That's the explosion outside. So evidence seems to indicate, and these are facts that don't counter emotions. What we've been seeing back and forth all morning long is the emotions on both sides. Hey, we've got the facts versus the opinion. That's warfare. Unfortunately, that's what always happens in war. You have to contend with.
Truth is the first casualty, as it's famously said.
Yeah, and I think one of the big questions President Biden will face after he's done with his meetings when he comes to speak, if he takes any questions during his remarks, is what made him conclude, right, based on these issues that you're laying out, whether U.S. intelligence has an assessment? We don't know yet.
I would venture to say that U.S. intelligence has additive intelligence to what
this.
Israel.
And we know that they had obtained, or the Israelis had passed over their intelligence as well. Right. Lieutenant General Mark Hertling, appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah. Poppy?
So with us now at the desk.
So Clutch Cargo, that's a very good question. Clutch Cargo asking, what would the motivation be for the Israeli government to bomb the hospital? And the most credible one that I could think of was if they're serious about their ethnic cleansing of that area, you know, you would want to destroy the hospital so that, you know, people would stop, you know, depending on that hospital to go there. But they didn't destroy the hospital. So, I mean, that doesn't, you know, that doesn't support my argument. If they really did, you know, want to go forward, you know, with that, why not just destroy the whole hospital then? They didn't do that. Well, we don't know who did it, right? But it was not an attempt to destroy the building. It honestly does look like just a big cock up by Hamas. Like, I'm still on the fence. I need that independent analysis. I need something. I need something more than either the Palestinian, you know, someone from Palestine saying it, or something, someone from Israel saying. I need something a little bit more than that. But that's really the only thing I could think of, was that, you know, if you would want to make the hospital, you would want to destroy the hospital, right, to further this ethnic cleansing campaign that may be happening. I have a really good feeling that the goal is to destroy Palestine, to absorb Palestine, but maybe they're getting, you know, wet feet here. When it, you know, they got their troops lined up, but the United States is saying in the back, we're not going to have your back on this occupation. You're going to have to go it alone. And maybe they're questioning it. I'm going on a rant here, but that's the only credible thing I could think of, is that if you're legitimately ethnically cleansing this area, yeah, destroying the hospital would be pretty essential in that campaign. But they didn't destroy the hospital, so.
Editor and foreign affairs columnist for Bloomberg, Bobby Ghosh. Bobby, thanks very much for being here. I want to start with something that we just heard from our one of our foreign policy analysts, Rula Jabal, who has so much experience in the region. She said, this sadly could become America's war. This is what President Biden is trying to prevent.
So Fathad over here, Jim Moneymaker over here, talking about how Israel can't come to any agreements because Hamas is using human shields. I want to ask, you know, Fathead here, as well as, you know, all the other Israeli defenders, what are these border cities if not human shields? One of the first things Israeli settlers do when they take over a house is they move in women and children. They immediately move in women and children. They immediately weaponize women and children. What are those people? What are these settlers that are on these border towns, if anything but human shields? They're totally oblivious, apparently, to the fact that they're on the fucking frontier of an occupation. This is just a real estate opportunity. So I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I don't know the politics around here. I just bought a house. I don't know. It was really cheap. Really? Seemingly so. These people in these kibbutz, they didn't have guns. They didn't have, you know, they were fully dependent on the occupation forces to defend them. And they completely dropped the ball. Being attacked. Yeah. So this human shield argument is questionable to me, because I have a hard time not seeing these border towns, these settlements, as attempts to weaponize civilians. Like I said, the first thing that they do is move in the women and children, right? So if the Palestinian resistance were to attack that house, they'd be killing women and children. It's the first thing they do. I have video evidence of it.
What do you think when you hear that, as he's there?
All right. So yeah, Davey was just wanting to talk about that first part. Thank you, Davey, for that. So this is that military analyst. This is a soldier. He's doing a lot of commentary on Ukraine, but he's talking about this as well. He had a few points. Israelis can be hypocrites. Yes, I thought you were saying can't. But no, of course they can. So he makes some, basically he makes the same kind of arguments that we just heard from the other guy. So I don't think we need to repeat it. With that said, if you want additional information, if you want an additional analysis of this from a military person, I do recommend you check out this link. Go ahead and give that a watch. Combat Veteran Reacts is the YouTube channel. Highly recommend you check him out. Thank you, Combat Veteran Reacts. So I feel like, just to be fair to the pro-Israeli argument, I'm going to show this. James O'Brien, absolutely at the latter half of this 9-minute clip, the 5-minute mark, basically, he takes callers from regular folks, and he absolutely shits on this woman who is trying to, you know, kind of give, you know, do the usual lefty, you know, lefty responses. And honestly, this is James O'Brien saying, we don't have proof either way. You can't be out here saying Israel bombed the hospital. Israel bombed. We literally don't have proof either way. You know, you're acting like a fool by, you know, vehemently saying absolutely Israel did it, just as the same as Israelis that are saying the opposite. Right. And it basically says anybody that's being certain about this is being dishonest. They're either being delusional or you're being dishonest. So I wanted to show this just out of fairness to the argument, because I do believe the left, who are repeating this narrative that 100% Israel bombed this hospital, I think they're doing a disservice to the narrative, and I do think that they need to be called out. So let's go ahead and watch this.
I think,
super fucking loud. Sorry about that. Let me just turn the volume down over here and on mine as well. Will I ever learn? That's the question. Will I literally ever learn? They're taking Palestinian homes. I saw a video of Palestinians screaming and selling their stuff. And he responds, he's never leaving. Well, if the video is the same video that you're talking about, that might be the fat guy from New York that said, if I'm not stealing your house, someone else will. And there's dozens and dozens of other videos. This whole idea that Palestine is the only one using civilians as human shields, I think is a bit of misinformation. Because like I said, the first thing Israeli settlers do is move in the women and children.
I think maybe it was...
Me too, Clutch.
Seeing what public opinion would be on that kind of thing.
That's silly. You know what public opinion would be on an army bombing a hospital. So this is the thing about conspiracy theories that always intrigues me. What do you think the plan was? Because you believed for a while that someone representing the Israeli government, even though they only bought their blue tick last month, but you can be forgiven for not checking that. He deliberately announced that Israel had bombed a hospital on behalf of the official government of Israel and then deleted it a few minutes later. What was the master plan, do you think?
I know. I got to get this mic. This mic is magic. These broadcasters have this is like a $1,000 mic, I'm sure. I got to get the upgrade. This Yeti mic is trash, dude. Beginner condenser. This thing fucking sucks.
That you fell for. I don't know how big a deal it is. It just seems a rather infelicitous thing to say, doesn't it? It looks like it was the other team. Twitter was appalling last night.
Jerry, I actually don't think it's justified for Israeli citizens and the Israeli government to just straight up steal Palestinian homes and take them over. I don't think that's justified. Do you think that's justified for Israeli citizens to just steal Palestinian homes and to occupy their land indefinitely? Is that what you think?
And I make no apology for citing Twitter as an example or an exemplar even of the place to go for breaking news. If you think back a year or 2 years, it was wonderful. I mean, it can be an absolute sewer on occasions, but it was so good on breaking news because of the verification system. So you knew that almost everybody who had a blue tick would be working for a reputable news organization in the context of bulletins.
You're not spitting facts, Jerry. You're not spitting facts. Okay? You can call it what you can call it settling, you can call it whatever it is. It's occupation. It's stealing. It's colonization. That's what it is. You give it whatever fucking fancy term you want, settling. It's occupation.
Coming from world's trouble spots, you know. Obviously you also get a blue tick if you're a superstar. Singer and stuff like that. But if you were looking at claims or reports, or you were looking at tweets claiming to be reports, it was fairly easy to establish whether or not it was coming from somebody who had credibility. God, it was awful. Awful last night. You couldn't really, can't use it anymore to track breaking
Twitter.
News,
it's trash. Obvious, Twitter's
so
a joke.
Using it leaves quite a big hole.
It does.
And some people.
Yeah, from the political perspective, James is 100% correct. It's like we've political junkies like me. We've lost an essential tool that we were using, and Elon Musk has completely fucked up the verification system. You can't trust anybody. And it's interesting that a lot of these falsehoods were started from an account that, you know, just bought its blue tick and said, I'm a representative of the Israeli government, and everyone just went with it.
When this dreadful hospital explosion, hospital blast started being reported, it was...
Fathad, I mean, that's not totally true, but I do agree that there is a lot of Hamas, PLO, lefty, tanky lefty generated misinformation. But so often... I'm not going to buy that because there's a lot of video evidence. There's a lot of pictures. There's a lot of substantive evidence that supports the fact that Israel is oppressing the Palestinian people. So it's, you know, yes, there's a lot of false, you know, like the death toll that we're hearing from this hospital being 500 people. Wild. No fucking way. No fucking way. No fucking way.
Was reported as if people knew what they were talking about. It was reported as if the facts had already been established.
And I agree.
The facts still haven't been established. It's 12 hours later, and it is into that confusion that Joe Biden just waded. And Idiot's Corner would be inappropriate today, but if you haven't double, triple, and quadruple checked whatever it is that you are thinking of texting to me, or more importantly, whatever it is you are choosing to believe about this explosion at this hospital, then you are actually doing a grave disservice to the dead, I would suggest. And at the very, very least, we all owe them caution in concluding what has happened.
I agree with that.
The rush to judgment is often wrong.
I agree.
I would go as far as to say that you insult the memory of the people who have died by claiming certainty already.
Now, I agree with James, but I will reiterate that Israel has already bombed a hospital and has in the past bombed and, I believe, destroyed hospitals. That's not an excuse to repeat a falsehood, but there is a history. There is a context here. It's not coming out of the blue. You know, it's not just pulled out of the air. There is a history of Israel targeting hospitals. Thank you for the follow, brother.
Claiming an impossible certainty.
No, brother, and you're literally being called out by James in this video, brother Mid. You're literally being called out in this video. It was definitely Israel. Step back from that, because honestly, I the evidence right now does not support that. Even though Israel is historically dishonest, the evidence that we have seen right now is leaning towards Hamas fucking it up, you know, firing a shoddy rocket in the sky. As dishonest as Israel's history is being right now, that is the evidence that we've seen. So to say definitely with 100% certainty, you're making a little bit of a fool of yourself. Thank you for that follow, V-Bars.
So I would go as far as to say that you insult the memory of the people who have died by claiming certainty already, by claiming an impossible certainty.
See what I mean?
About what happened.
You're literally being called out, brother.
You know, had to keep a very even keel throughout the last week and a half. Had to be very, very careful.
Yeah, me too.
And rightly so.
Yeah,
as we wade into incredibly complicated and heartbreaking territory. But the closest I get to losing my patience, I think, is with people who are insisting
that they know
exactly what happened in circumstances where it is currently impossible to do so. And I mean, it's odd, isn't it, that we started... I'm not going to get too distracted by this, but clarity is important. I started off this morning talking about how sad it was that you can't rely on Twitter because of
Davey, you're being just as silly by saying with 100% certainty that he's wrong. You can say that he's wrong with his certainty, but you can't say with 100% certainty that whatever source that he's sourcing is incorrect. You don't know either.
Corruption of its verification system by Elon Musk to identify sources that are credible. No one's ever infallible, but sources that are credible as opposed to sources that are clearly not credible. Anybody can buy a blue tick. And this social media influencer...
Who garbage.
...also does some work in the digital...
Twitter is trash.
...department of the Israeli government. That's the claim, I think, that is true, but he's also got his own Patreon account on his Twitter page looking for donations and passing the hat around. So,
and you're making a fucking fool of yourself, Davey. You're not a video forensic expert. You're not a missile expert. You know, you're a little bit closer to the government than most of us with your occupation, but you're making a fool of yourself. He said the website said the rocket video is old. You have no idea, dude. It's a dark fucking video. It could be from fucking anything.
So he is absolutely and categorically not an official government spokesman.
Exactly, V-Bars.
I would argue, given that he posted that Israel had attacked this hospital and then very quickly deleted it. He's also clearly not a credible source with a bought blue tick. But, and this is the point that that Sam makes so well. Everyone's now fixated on who is to blame for yesterday's holiday hospital attack. Surely it's time to think about the horrific loss of life and those suffering. I agree with you, but the argument will rage about who was responsible for the attack forever now, because even if it is conclusively proved that it was X as opposed to Y, Y will claim that X has influenced the investigation, or that Y can't be trusted.
Fake news.
So you're back to the importance of supranational organizations that transcend any loyalty, whether it's tribal or otherwise. But you cannot argue with a straight face that someone who describes himself as a media personality and has a cap, passing his cap around on social media with a paid for blue tick, would have been speaking officially for the Israeli government.
He's talking about this Twitter account that, you know, was created like a month ago, bought a blue tick, bought a verification, said I'm a representative of the Israeli government and we definitely bombed the hospital, and then deleted the tweet. That's what he's talking about.
Last night, deliberately revealing that they'd bombed the hospital and then deleting it.
Hey, brother Mid, maybe these people that are, you know, hardcore destroy Israel, jihad for life, maybe they should stop representing the entirety of the Palestinian country and people, because they don't. I refuse to believe that 40% of Palestinian children in the Gaza Strip are like super pro kill everybody. Last time I checked, children are inherently innocent.
It doesn't fit any narrative, however warped it may be. But of course, a million people.
I don't know, Clutch.
Or a bazillion people claim that it fits whatever narrative it is that they want it to fit.
I was very All right. quick.
So here you go. This is James, you know, giving the left a spanking that it deserves. All right, and it's a shame that person I had to ban on. On Discord, didn't watch my 3 days of coverage before I left for my road trip to San Jose. It's a shame that person didn't watch any of that and just said, I'm super pro Hamas, because I wish that person could be here with us now, seeing all the context, all the nuance, all the hatred I have for Hamas and terrorism, and seeing my attempt to try and present both sides of this argument. It really is a shame that I'm still being called a fucking echo chamber. Me, the News Underground, an echo chamber. Are you kidding me? I can't agree with people on butter on toast in this chat. I can't. The sky is blue and we're going to have a 20-minute fucking debate on that one. You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. No, I'm a fucking echo chamber. Fuck off.
To look at all the information coming out last night, particularly with that digital media influencer
family
been appointed by Netanyahu.
Yeah.
You know, so I think just because I'd been so consumed and so quickly swiping through stuff, I should have taken a step back on that.
Yes.
What I would say,
well,
is
we've all been there. We've all been guilty of that.
Yeah, what I would say on the question of the blast itself is, you know, do Hamas have the kind of artillery to inflict that power, to inflict that level of destruction? Looking at Israel's past, you know.
See, this is a person that is not looking at the evidence. This is a person that is listening to narratives and picking one. Because in an honest look at the evidence, it's not incredibly destructive, actually.
It strikes.
It did kill a lot of people, but that, you know, like we've seen, you know, Israel has bombs that can absolutely wreck some shit.
Hospitals and things like that. And also, I would hope that the investigation is done by an outside party, because Israel does have a history of, you know, saying it hasn't done something, quietly admitting months later when the world has moved on.
Yes.
Fathad, we're not going to get into it. Jim Jordan, a proud insurrectionist who planned the January 6th insurrection, is on the cusp of being the fucking leader of the Republican Party. Yes, the Republican Party is fascist. And yes, people that support the Republican Party support fascism. Unequivocally, full stop. Stop making excuses for fucking insurrectionists, man.
No, I think you're allowed to say that, but the evidence will be fairly incontrovertible, and when it is finally examined and when it finally emerges. But I mean, I don't really want to go down that rabbit hole, and we haven't been having a phone in about who do you trust on the question of what happened last night, for reasons that are fairly obvious, in that nobody knows, so everything is an opinion. And as you acknowledge, yours was quite easily swayed by a fairly ridiculous source. So very briefly, why would somebody acting on behalf of the Israeli government announce that they'd bombed a hospital and then delete it? What would be the master plan there?
I think maybe it was as part of the kind of seeing what public opinion would be on that kind of thing.
That's silly. You know what public opinion would be on an army bombing a hospital. So this is the thing about conspiracy theories that always intrigues me. What do you think the plan was? Because you believed for a while that someone representing the Israeli government, even though they only bought their blue tick last month, but you can be forgiven for not checking that, he deliberately announced that Israel had bombed a hospital on behalf of the official government of Israel and then deleted.
Yeah, it does. It would make more sense if Israel just annihilated the hospital. It's not like Israel hasn't participated in revenge in the past, intentionally targeting civilian populated areas and using ordnance that is, capable of producing the most amount of damage to civilians in that area. Israel has done that in the past, out of revenge. In this case, it doesn't seem as likely. But with that said, Israel has absolutely participated in the politics of revenge against Palestinian civilians specifically.
It a few minutes later. What was the master plan, do you think, that you fell for?
I don't think that's the case this time, though.
It doesn't make sense.
After I'd seen the bombing itself.
Yeah. So what was the master plan by tweeting it and then deleting it from the position of being a member of the Israeli government, which, of course, he wasn't?
I honestly don't know whether
well, that's the question you've got to ask yourself before you decide that it's persuasive or in any way worth contemplating or considering. You've got to ask yourself what the master plan is.
Considering the amount of bombing that had happened this past week,
I show those clips as best I can, brother. You're a new viewer of the News Underground, but no, I absolutely show Al Jazeera and other Arab news, Japanese news, German news, French news. I do show those different angles. Unfortunately, I don't have time for this 3-hour stream to do that, but if you stick around to the News Underground, you would see that I do actually cover those sources, and I do show as much of that as Jeff will let me.
Talking about a completely unreliable source that you chose to believe, but without really stopping to think about what it was you were choosing to believe.
It was kind of confirmation bias.
Yes, that's very honest of you.
After seeing the amount of posts that are coming out.
Again, you're not addressing the central question.
I do.
There is no explanation of why, even if he was who you believed he was, which he wasn't, he would have done the thing that you think he did. And it wasn't even him, of course, as it's turned out subsequently. It was his wife. Hush. On an account that bought a blue tick last month. But there you go. That is the nature of the line, if you like, between misinformation and disinformation. It's misinformation when you fall for it. It's disinformation when you continue to disseminate it.
Exactly. No, and that's such a great point. It's misinformation if you fall for it. We're all human. It's happened to me. It's happened to you. It's happened to everybody. I thought that shit was real. So that's happened. But it turns into disinformation when... You've received some credible pushback on that narrative, and you choose to repeat that narrative anyway instead of reanalyzing that narrative and trying to find because it is nuance sucks. The reason why this channel a lot of people don't like it is because I grind it to a halt to have a debate about the morality of this and that, or the philosophical necessity or the political effectiveness of this and that, right? The nuance, the context, right? It's actually really, really hard to do. It's really difficult, especially in this format where you're supposed to keep it snappy and keep it moving. But I refuse to let these falsehoods be perpetuated on my network, on my channel. I refuse that. And sometimes that means grinding the whole fucking stream to a halt to, explain that, yes, the fascistic Republicans are implementing fascism and the people that support them support fascism. Does that mean every single Republican voting for fascism is technically a fascist? No. But does that even fucking matter at this point when they're supporting a fascistic regime ignorantly or, you know, full-throatedly? Does it even matter if they're winning and they're, look at the poll numbers with Trump and Biden. Look how close Jim Jordan was to the fucking speakership of the House. Do you know the speakership of the House is number three in power? It's the president, vice president, and the speaker of the fucking House. Jim Jordan, an insurrectionist who planned and implemented a fucking coup against the American democracy, is going to be the leader of the Republican Party, or was just barely about to be. And they're going to be doing another vote tomorrow, number three, probably for Jim Jordan. They're still not making that decision that we need to throw away MAGA and the fascists. They're embracing MAGA and the fascists. Jim Jordan had over 200 votes in the House of Congress, 200 other Republicans who agree that they should be led by a fascistic insurrectionist. Get the fuck out of here with that nonsense.
Knowing that it's not true.
The fuck out of here with that fucking nonsense. Oh, no, we're not fascist. We just fully support a fascist agenda and a fascist party implementing anti-democratic fascism. But we're not fascist. Fuck you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Jim Moneymaker. Maybe not fuck you, but fuck your entire theory that the Republican Party is somehow redeemable. That they haven't jumped off a cliff willingly and are currently every single day attempting to subvert our democracy. That is a fact. All right, so here's the last video for today. A little dark humor for everybody. I thought I would end it on a little bit of dark humor. And it pertains to kids as human shields, a subject we were just talking about. So there you go.
First of all, what is your reaction to what happened on October the 7th?
Oh, it was terrible, of course. I mean, we kind of get our news kind of also secondhand because, you know, my wife's family, they live in Gaza. They have cousins and uncles there. And their house also was bombed. We haven't been able to communicate with them for the past 3 days. Communication are lost. So we don't know actually what is the, how are they doing? But, you know, we're used to that. I mean, it's very repetitive. We're used to that. We're used to them being bombed every time and moving from one place to the other. You know, it's just like those Palestinians, they're very dramatic. Ah, Israel killing us. But they never die. I mean, they always come back. You know, they're very difficult to kill, very difficult people to kill. I know because I'm married to one. I tried many times, couldn't kill them.
I mean, there's a dark humor there, and I understand why. Because
no, it's not dark humor. I try to get to her every time, but she uses our kids as human shields. I can never take her out.
It's like a weird, twisted Rodney Dangerfield, you know, Rodney Dangerfield bit. I tried to kill my wife, but she used the kids as a human shield. I tell you, I get no respect around here. I get no respect. I get no respect. I try to, you know, it's impossible to kill a Palestinian. You know, I've been trying to kill my wife for years. She can't do it. She used my kids as human shields. There you go, folks. That's the coverage I have today. You know, I know it's taken me too long. Whoa, Jesus Christ. I know it's taken me far too long to get out here and push back against some of these insane genocidal narratives. Oh, the only solution is kill, 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 kill. Left and the right does it. Kill, 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 kill. It's all justified. My side does no wrong. Your side does all the wrong. Everything's justified. It's disgusting. So I had to get on air. I had to do this. Even though I'm kind of on vacation, I guess. I'm still working and taking care of the kid. Doesn't feel like a fucking vacation, I tell you that. But, you know, thank you for being here. I hope you were informed. I know this probably wasn't enjoyable, but I hope you were informed. I hope you had a healthy debate. And we got, you know, we got a little bit closer to the truth, maybe. I don't know. I want to give props to literally everyone in the chat. Yeah, V-Bars. The News Underground is different. The News Underground is different than these other political jokesters on this fucking platform. I run a real news channel. Substantive news. Real discussions. Not this fucking self-flagellation that I'm seeing on Just Chatting. This masturbation I'm seeing on the left. On these streaming platforms. There's very few leftist streamers in the politics world that I have respect for. Mike Figurino is one of them. I got a lot of respect for Mike. But thank you, Brother Mid. Thank you, Rebel Phoenix. Yeah, Rebel Phoenix, totally true. I'm not raiding anybody, but thank you for being here, Fathad. Thank you, Clutch Cargo. Thank you again, Davey, V-Bars, everybody in the chat. You know, your boy Lenny. Thank you, Lenny, for being here. Thank you, Chem Goblin, for being here. I don't regret banning the person that I banned in the Discord, but I do regret that it had to come to that, because I did like this person. I had respect for this person that I had to ban in the Discord, but I absolutely refuse to accept nationalism as an excuse for genocide. And religion as well. Throw religion on top of that as well. Thank you, Ben Tao. Thank you, Benatao, for coming in. Thank you, Trailhead, for coming here. Very much appreciate it. Thank you, Clutch Cargo, if I already said that. You know, big props to any of you in the chat. You know, you're making chats. I do appreciate that. Thank you for being here. Big props to Davin. Thank you, Davin, for being here. Big props to you, Davin. But yeah, this is the motherfucking News Underground. I am abandoned nihilism. Peace in that motherfucking Middle East, and glory to the Ukrainian democracy. Because the secret formula to create political change is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Step 1, inform yourself, which is what you did today. Step 2, join a progressive political organization in your area. And step 3, put in the work. Maybe it's a union. Maybe you're running for office. Maybe it's a school board meeting. Maybe it's a canvassing job for single-payer healthcare. You have to put in the work. The fascists are putting in the work. Steve Bannon is putting in the work. Steve Bannon and fucking Kirk, I'm going to call him Kirk Douglas, TPUSA, they're putting in the work. Charlie Kirk, they're putting in the work. We need to push back on them. The left needs to push back. The left needs to get serious about political activism. And you can do that by following a 3-step program. It is literally that simple to create political change. Stop the bullshit. It's actually not that difficult to push back and claw some rights back from the oligarchy, from the empire. It is actually not impossible. Thank you, Davey. I'm going to be doing more streams, but they're going to be, you know, I'm not going to be able to be consistent, but I will try to get something in on Saturday or Sunday. I will try to get more streams going here. I'm going to do the best that I can, but, you know, IRL. But thank you, everybody. Once again, peace in that motherfucking Middle East. And glory to the Ukrainian democracy. Thank you for being here. I'm abandoned nihilism, the harbinger of things to come, and this is the News Underground, folks. I'm gonna go smoke some weed. Thank you for Thod, Mr. Jim Moneymaker. Thank you for coming. Listening to Slick Wolf, Joyriders. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Rebel. Smoke a fat one. Davey's not wrong. I did one marijuana. Now look at me. That's all it takes, one marijuana. Turns you into an addict for life. Disgusting. I'm a fucking junkie. Bye! You know we have so much fun. I have a hard time leaving. We have so much fun. Hippie. Ah, you know, okay, I'll take that. I'll take that. Yeah, collusion. Could you imagine? Fentanyl in your weed? Holy shit. Fentanyl in your weed. No. Thank you for coming back, Collusion. We'll see you next time. Thank you, everybody. Hey, if you're in San Francisco, and you want to come to a Halloween party, hit me up in the DMs. If you live in the San Francisco area and you want to come to the best Halloween party, DJ'd by your boy, a band of Nihilism, hit me up in the DMs. I'll give you a special invite. Halloween party. Not this Saturday, but next Saturday. San Francisco area, hit me up. Hey, it's not for everybody. It's not for everybody. That's fine. Oh, poor Davey. No. Oh, no. Oh, you poor guy. It's not for everybody. That's okay. No problem. Props to my straight edge friends. Being straight edge is cool. Not really, but we'll just pretend. Oh no, you took a huge gravity bong hit. Yeah, no, you don't. it's like the first time drinker drinking like half a bottle of whiskey. It's like, that's not how you should you got to start off a little bit more gentle. All right, folks, that's it for me. Thank you for being here and have a good night.